sold-out Alumni Stadium on the beautiful campus here at the University of Guelph. My name is Peter Cobb, and yes, sitting next to me, you know him as the wizard from Wallaceburg. He is Mr. Sean Patrick Moynihan, and Mr. Moynihan, we have the 2-0 Laurier Golden Hawks, and we're going to pause for the national anthem. Let's head down to Scotty Frazier on the sideline.
Just another Saturday here at Alumni Stadium. Fall is upon us and football season in full swing. The Guelph Gryphons return home after a slobber knocker down in Windsor 1 week ago. The good news for the Griffs, though, undefeated here at Alumni Stadium so far this year with a 1-0 record. And coming back here for the O-week game, which means a packed crowd is in the house. Guelph using that 13th man already to get the anthem going. And the Gryphons will really look for a bounce back effort after that loss 1 week ago. Laurier comes into this game 2-0, but really has a long story history with these Gryphons. This will be the 38th meeting between these two teams. Laurier owns that series 25-12. However, Guelph 6-4.
Scotty wasn't with us the last broadcast, but man, is he in rare form now.
Oh, it's great to have him on the sidelines.
Pete, it's good to be back here in Guelph for another football game. Week one, we were overjoyed with the performance of the Guelph Gryphons. Two rookie quarterbacks, tremendous poise for being first-year kids. However, last week in Windsor, a really difficult experience for Guelph. I have to watch that game. And was pretty much overwhelmed.
Well, I turned to reruns of Hee Haw because it was so depressing.
Yeah, last week, you know, Pete, Guelph gave up so many yards on the ground. I think they gave up 488 yards on the ground. And to me, that's got to be job one today.
Is clean that up.
Clean up that that run. But we have the Laurier country right now, but game one of the season, they marched down to Queens and pulled out an 11-10 win. I think it was a big surprise to a lot of people, as people kind of had Queens up there as maybe number two in the OUA. But they have got some real superstars there.
Oh, we can, you do, yeah, absolutely. We can see the coin toss, and referee Kevin Baird is pointing that Guelph has won the toss. Guelph will receive the football. And that means the Laurier Golden Hawks will play defense to start. But I think you're right, Sean. You know, we've got key injuries. You know, our hearts were broken when we saw after the third or fourth play the injury to Isaiah Smith. You know, we saw him pre, and he was so fired up. And a mountain of a man, he'd spilled out so much. He was a rookie of the year before. And then bingo, your fortunes could change.
Well, he's out for the year, Pete. Number 26, Isaiah Smith, second year running back. Well, you said OUA rookie of the year. And but do not sleep on Donovan Malloy.
Malloy, he had a big game in Windsor. Let's see if he can.
Tremendous game.
Might be his coming out party.
A little different style of a running back,
yep.
More of a shifty speedster, where Isaiah is more of a straight-on power back. But listen, Pete, a couple big names to watch today for Laurier. Their quarterback, I really like.
Boy.
Taylor Ergasma. Boy, week one, he was 30 for 39, 22 of 32 last week. I'll tell you, he is a surgeon out there and a third-year kid from London, Ontario. Look out for him today. As as you said, though, Guelph's going to take this kickoff, and we need some offense immediately, Peter.
Well, and, you know, we've got two kids at quarterback for the Gryphons. We've got Tristan Abood, who's shown, boy, that week one against Toronto. I thought, my goodness, he's got veteran presence back there.
For sure.
Things happened a little quicker a week ago for him. And then, of course,
protection.
There's a new, yeah, protection, protection to you, right. There's a new Marshall in town. He had a big second half. And as Coach Shane told us, when you got a kid with that athleticism, you got to find a spot to get him in the game and
for
get
sure.
him to make plays. We're just about ready to go, and here comes the opening kickoff.
They're going to Vishon right off the bat.
All right, he's got it around his own one-yard line, heading up across the 10, up through the middle, and brought down before the 20. We'll say the 18-yard line is where the Gryphons will begin their offense.
Pete, just no room for Vishon Genesis. First team OUA last year.
Yeah, they've got to get the ball to him. He's a difference maker. Let's see. There's a good shot of Tristan Abood, number 8. Tall, lanky kid. He can throw the country mile. All right. Running in motion, number 7. Here's the fake handoff, rolling and cutting up the middle and running and gaining of about 5 yards. And, you know, we saw this in week one. We didn't know Tristan Abood could take off and run, but he's got a little bit of Patty Mahomes in him.
I bet you. You know, gotta believe the coaching staff wants to throw the ball, though. However, a good pickup of 5 yards.
Second and 5, it's manageable. Tristan Abood, he wears number 8. 3 receivers out here to the right, 2 to the left, 1 setback, that's Malloy. Lots of motion, lots of shifting. There's a fake handoff. No, the ball is handed off and going to be short of that first down is Malloy. And here comes the punt team. So Laurier defense, that's what they want. You know, we talked about to Coach Halls, and he said, hey, we want to get that ball early and we want to get on them early.
Brandon Lemonwall, he made a nice tackle there and closed up what appeared to be a hole for Donovan. But here we go, Pete, punting situation. For Guelph.
All right. Ball is snapped. Punt, end over end kick. Gonna be bouncing around the 50 and scooped up and dropped. Hold it. There's 2 flags and it probably is gonna be no yards of the 5 yard. We got Murray Drinkwalder up here in the booth with us, and boy, we're grateful because Murray is the supervisor of officials. And anytime there's a questionable call, he's the guy. He can tell us what the signals are and everything.
Gives us the details, the ins and outs. Really great to have Murray back in the booth with us.
Yeah, we're very fortunate. Our referee is Kevin Baird. The umpire, Paul Duncan. There you can see them marching off the 5 yards. Let's see where Mr. Elder is going to lead. He's in the shotgun formation. 3 receivers to the right. And look out for number 4, the kid from the Maple City, Ethan Jordan, who is first team all UA. He's coming in motion now. They fake the handoff, they get it to him out in the slot. He's got a blocker in front of him, and it's a solid gain of at least 9 yards. Boy, they ran Jordan in motion and got him the ball quickly.
Jordan had 9 receptions last week. Last year, he led the OUA in yards per game at 24, and this has a rookie. They love to get that kid the ball.
Second and about 1. This is very manageable. This is what you want. And 3 down football again. There's the throw out into the flat. Jordan again, same, very similar play. Gain of 6 and a first down. And the Golden Hawks have the ball at the 35-yard line of the Guelph Gryphons right away. So
see, this is what happened last week. First possession, Guelph ended up punting the ball. Did not turn the field over. And again today, you know, Waterloo starts at their own 50, great field position. Taylor Ergesma got him on the move.
All right, Ergesma back looking, throws that ball across the middle, and it's caught up the middle, and it's gonna be a touchdown, Sean. And that looks like number 18, Raiden Thorne, and we heard about him from offensive coordinator, for Mr. Galloway.
For sure, Pete, and we'll see on the replay in a minute. He caught underneath Jordan.
Well, watch this throw, folks. Standing tall, looking, throwing that ball, a perfect pass across the middle. And number six, Nathaniel Slaughter, just a step behind Guthrie, didn't have a chance. And boy, if you're a Golden Hawk fan, that's just what the doctor ordered.
For sure, Pete. And this passing game of Laurier is tough. And as we mentioned earlier, Laurier has climbed to six in the nation.
Well, and Coach Fault said he hadn't felt they played their best football yet, and he expected this team was going to be well prepared for today. Well, the first series is any indication, Sean. Three plays, and they're in the end zone.
For sure.
All right, well, we will see. It's going to be tough. Sometimes when you get whacked early like that, you can do one of two things. It can break your spirit coming off last week, or you can say, okay, that's enough. It's our turn to snap back, and let's see how the Gryphons respond here on this pickup.
With 3-3 down football, it's really about turning over the field, and it just didn't happen that time for Guelph. And Pete, I want to mention Anakin Guthrie, the DB back to receive this this kickoff. He is the electrifying in open space. And I gotta believe we're gonna see him make a big, either a punt return or kickoff return this year.
Let's hope it's today, kids.
Let's hope it's in the next.
Guthrie and Genesis are back deep for the Gryphons. And here comes the kickoff from number 22, Dawson Hodge. And it's bobbled and a fake handoff. And coming this way, Genesis has some running room. He gets to the 30, the 35, and finally brought down around the 36-yard line. Excellent starting field position and gives these Gryphon fans something to cheer about.
It's better, Deshaun. That was almost a line drive of a kick, but found a hole here. And nice block on the inside there, and a lot of tackle there.
McDougal, Brendan McDougal, Brave McDougal had a nice block there too to allow. Okay, three receivers, Sean, out to the left, one here to the right, one set back is Malloy. Lots of motion. Abood has the ball, turns, hands it off to Malloy, heading straight up the gut, and a nice run of about, let's say, 6 yards.
For sure, Pete. Donovan, number 23, Malloy. We heard a lot about him in camp, that he was going to surprise people with his speed. He had a 75-yarder last weekend in Windsor.
Well, and you know, when Smith went down, it's next man up, and Malloy proving that he is the man. All right, second down and about four. You know, you talk about big plays early. This is another key play. You'd like to see the Gryphons get an extended drive and get that first down. And off again to Malloy. He gets to the outside. He's still on his feet, Sean, and there he goes. And look at him go all the way to the 50-yard line.
And
Mr.
Pete,
Malloy.
And maybe a saving tackle, and I'm going to try to get this name right. Io Ajayi made a big saving tackle, number one, for Waterloo, and maybe caught Waterloo a little off guard, thinking the ball was going to be tossed up in the air that time. However, lots of confidence.
Yeah, Ajayi there. We're going to apologize. There are some difficult pronunciations. We're going to do our best to the Golden Hawk family, that's for sure. Rolling and throwing across the middle. Got a man open, and it's Cock, and making his way and weaving to the outside. He's at the 15 and brought down at the 10-yard line. Sean, that's number
William
five,
Willard Arsenal.
What a play by Abudi. Hung in the pocket there and made a bullet pass.
And Arsenal is a first-year kid, Pete, and that's his biggest catch of the year.
Watch this, folks. He has steps in and then stays with it and throws a dart. And I'm going to tell you, the rest is Arsenal. And he, and you are right, Nico McCarthy, number three, made a saving tackle. Otherwise, that was six. All right, the Gryphons responding how we wanted them. Ball now at the 10-yard line of the Golden Hawks. The Hawks lead it 7-0. Back to pass, looking, throwing long and deep into the end zone. Arsenal just overthrown. He was open.
He had him. Again, great protection that time for a boot in the pocket. Just misses Arsenal again.
Good job by this offensive line. Look at that. And Abood is, you know, over 6 feet tall, so he's got the height to stand back there, as well as Elgersman. He's a big kid, too. You can see over that offensive line and see downfield.
Pete, you couldn't help but notice on that play, Malloy was open in the flat. Just look and see if maybe that's where they go now.
All right, second and 10. There's the fake handoff, throw it in. What a defensive play there.
Christian Nistum. Christian Nistum, Pete, yeah, just absolutely ate that up.
And here comes the field goal unit.
And Pete, that name's pronounced Insatum. Insatum.
Insatum, yeah.
Big number 77, big play in the game, and likely just saved him 4 points.
Here's Gabriel Canabara, I think it's pronounced. He's from, well, they say Toronto, but originally from Brazil. Where's number 70? Doing the field goal, the kickoff duties. Ball's down, the kick is up. It looks good, and it is good. And so, with 10:06 to go here in the first quarter, the Gryphons respond with a field goal. It's 7-3 for the Golden Hawks. And we shall see this offense start off again. They only took 3 plays, Sean, to get into the end zone.
Well, just a great response, Pete, after that big touchdown pass by Waterloo to open the scoring.
Taylor Elgersma, number 13. One running back, 2 receivers to his left. That running back to his left, number 14. Oh, that ball was almost intercepted by number
Gianni Green.
Gianni Green, he read that right away, and it's going to be second and long. And boy, you talk about games within the game. These little key plays right here, second and long, you just got a field goal. Now, if you can stop them and force them to punt, your offense is right back out on the field, playing with a little bit of confidence.
And Pete, they're going to need to get some pressure on Ergisma. If this kid has time, he is surgical.
All right, here we go. Back to pass. He's got that time. Throws across the middle. The ball is caught by number 4, the Maple City Wonder. And he signals first down. That's Ethan Jordan, his dad, Sal, a tremendous football player. And does a lot for Cougar football back home. That's for darn sure.
Well, we've heard a lot about Ethan Jordan. He got last year as a freshman.
Got an injury.
First team
here,
all-star. And
yeah, that's a big play. Second and long. And we can't quite get
that's
the,
Josh Campbell,
Josh
I believe.
Campbell
Pete,
down.
Number 96.
Yeah.
He is a real veteran here. Defensive lineman for Guelph.
Boy,
in his fourth
tell.
Year.
Comes Coach Sheehan out too. And whenever the coach comes out, he wants to make sure it's, that he's going to be okay. Like you say, a veteran presence. He's, Coach Sheehan has had just too many injuries to deal with.
Well, at our media timeout, Pete, we'll talk a little bit more about the injuries that Guelph has faced.
Oh,
that's all we talked about last year was how many kids went down with serious injury, and that injury bug has bit Guelph again this year early. You know, first game of the year here, Anthony Mortuzzo likely had one of the greatest defensive efforts we've seen in a Guelph uniform.
There goes Campbell under his own power. That's good sight. Number 96. Fourth year kid, 6'2". All right, it's going to be first down. The ball is at the 54-yard line. Yard away from midfield, 3 receivers to the right, 2 to the left. Bounce set back. Elgersma back. Big rush. Oh, the screen pass. And what a call. And rumbling down the field for another first down at number
Quentin
14.
Scott, Pete.
Quentin Scott.
He's
boy, what a call.
He's kind of their go-to running back. And it was from up here in our booth. Got a nice view, top of the field. And wow, that was almost too easy.
Yeah.
What a call by Michael Foltz.
Well, that's Coach
Todd
Galloway.
Galloway. That's Todd Galloway.
What a great to see him today. All right, Elgersma, draw play. Oh, face mask. And breaking a tackle regardless. The flag is thrown and finally brought down about the 18-yard line. But you saw 2 flags, and that's going to be a face mask. And I'm going to ask Murray, is that going to be added on to the play? And it will. We got the nod.
Sure, Pete. Again, that's Quentin Scott going through the middle. He is a load.
Yeah, one of the Gryphon linebackers fell down, and that's how he gained an extra 12 yards. You see where they march his ball. Looks like it's going all the way to the 1 yard line, Sean. So it's first and goal with the Gryphons making substitutions.
And you can see they bring in the
jumbo offense. They got two receivers out to the right. And the lone setback is Tanner now, number two, I believe, in the backfield there for the Golden Hawks. Let's see what Algersma does. Oh, somebody jumped offside. And hopping across, and a touchdown.
Yeah, that was, I believe that was Guelph offside, Pete, on that play, so that would be declined. And look out, scout, the Laurier offenses.
Yeah. You can see Algersma celebrating with number two. You know, it's really interesting. We had a great talk with Coach Falls. You know, he said, you know, over the past couple of years, we found ways of losing those close football games. Well, now we're finding ways of winning it. And that's the maturity of a football club. I found that very
I think a lot starts with their quarterback play, too, though.
Without question. He's solid.
He has matured, and he is the real deal.
The extra point is up and good by Dawson Hodge. And so, with 8:17 to go, the Golden Hawks have had the ball twice. They've scored twice. It's 14-3. Let's see if the Gryphons can respond. But defensively, they're going to have to get something done, because they had him in that second and long, and you might have to put double coverage on number four. That's for darn sure, Ethan Jordan, because
he has four catches already early today. And Pete, just take a look at the records of these two teams. Laurier comes in here at 2-0. Won that opener, as we mentioned previously, 11-10 up in Kingston. What a game. Last week won 20-15. The Gryphons, of course, opened up at home here with a great 33-10 win over Toronto. Toronto scored a touchdown, I think the last play or second last play of the game. And last week they lost 41-18 down in the Rose City in Windsor. Hoping to rebound today. And here comes the kickoff. They've gone to Vishon Genesis twice now.
Twice, yeah. And they're keeping it away from Guthrie. And let's see what Hodge does here. Again, they go to Genesis. He's got the ball at his own 3-yard line. He now heads upfield, cuts to the right, tries to get to the outside, and is unable to do so. A fine initial play there by number 88, and that is Ryan Spate.
Spate made a good move to make the tackle in the open field. If not, Vishon has some room. If he gets around that corner,
he might have a few more yards for sure. Spate, last name T-I-T-T, I hope I pronounced that right. Again, we apologize to our viewers from the Laurier area. We're going to do our best with those names, but this football club has got 14 on the board already. 7:57 and counting. Abood's got the ball. He turns, hands off to Malloy, cuts to the outside, and he's going to be brought down by number five. Oh, my. Ife Onyenum. All right. Let me look at the pronunciation board. I did see his name earlier. Again, I apologize.
Yeah, it's Ife.
Ife. Ife made a great play. He made a great play, number five.
He's their big linebacker, Pete. He was, I believe, a second-team OUA All-Star last year.
Big play here, second and nine. Abood back to pass, got some time, throws it across the middle, got a man wide open, and a first down. That's number seven.
He's still moving.
Hold on, he's still going. I was ready to say he's down, and he's all the way to the 45-yard line. Citizen Kane Stevenson from Windsor, Ontario.
Pete, he just rolled off that block and kept going, and I think he fooled everyone.
Oh, he fooled this announcer. Watch this, folks. One, two guys. I thought, okay, you're down. No, I'm not done. And a nice hit there by number 23. Donovan Malloy came in and allowed Stevenson to gain that extra yardage. Here we go, Abood. Got the ball. Back to pass. Look, throws that quick out. Ball is hit, and what a hit. Oh, he had it for a moment. Get the number. I think number 89. Does that sound right, John?
No, it's 28. Cote Azor. This is a blast.
Yeah, but I think it's Paquin who is the receiver.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. 28 is right. And boy, he laid the lumber. Looked like Brian Branch of the victorious Detroit Lions. I'm not going to talk too much about them today, but I will.
We will at one point.
All right. Second down and 10. Back to pass. Abood looks, throws it across. Got it in the middle, and Arsenault has got a first down. Willem, what a beautiful pass, and that's quick.
It's quick, Pete. Nico McCarthy on the hit to stop that play.
Look at that.
That's Arsenault again with a big catch.
Textbook tackling there, but the first down gets the ball into Golden Hawk territory.
And I'm sure, Pete, that's something they really want Abu to do more of, that quick
pass.
That quick pass.
All right, first down.
They're really high on his arm. They're amazed at his arm here in training camp.
Lots of motion. Ball on the 49-yard line. Turn, hand off, and rumbling for maybe one is Malloy. He was brought down almost immediately.
Brandon Omanyuta. Yep. Just a big whack.
Number
right
99,
off the
watch this. Boom. That's how you tackle, folks.
Omanyuta.
He's
made a couple big tacks. Yeah. We'll get that name right. Omanyuta.
Yeah, he's a big
kid for him.
Big kid. Gain of one. It's going to be second and nine. Ball at the 48-yard line of the Golden Hawks. They have the lead. 4:56 to go in the quarter. 14-3. The Golden Hawks have the lead. Abood back to pass, turns, fakes, and the draw play up the middle, and there goes Malloy, and what a run it is, and what a call! All the way to the 34-yard line. Let's see where they mark it.
And we're going to, after the play there, a little bit of action.
Yeah,
might be. Sean, and I think that's going to be a roughing penalty.
Yeah, unsportsmanlike or unnecessary roughness.
On number one there, Pete. We shouldn't try to call the game from up here like this.
Yeah, unnecessary roughness. Yeah, another 15 yards is marched off. Coach Balls will not like that.
Yeah, AJI with that penalty, Pete. And he and Vishon Genesis got tied up. But that's a killer of a penalty when you're down that deep.
Io AJI. AJI. And ooh, I don't like to see that. Number 11 on a knee. Favoring.
And Pete, while we've got a second, look at this monster crowd here
across
today.
Across the way, they're sitting on the
all the
field.
Students, it's orientation day here. Now during university, your university days, you would have been in the library at this time.
Well, I was a very studious individual and would have probably picked the game up on the radio somehow. Nice round of applause as Deshaun Genesis heads off under
Pete,
his own power.
Don't look now. The new Marshall in town is
oh
in.
Oh, my.
Marshall McCray
Marshall
into
McCray.
This game.
Ball is at the 18-yard line. It's a first down. And let's see. I love this kid. He's so, when we talk to him, he's so pleasant. Soft-spoken, but he is a demon on the football field, I'll tell you.
He's not afraid to throw the ball in the run, Pete, which I really
There's
like.
There's the fake handoff, and here goes Marshall, makes the move to the outside. Ooh, textbook tackle there by number 28. That's Malik Cote Azor. Yeah. Good play.
Cote Azor has had a couple big
whacks
in this game thus far. For a minute, it looked like Marshall was going around this corner, Pete. Well, he did a bit.
Yeah, he got a gain of eight, though. That's good textbook tackle. Gray will come off, and Abood comes back in. It's second down and two, John. Long setback is Mason Duval, number 42. And he's going to stay in the block. Abood throws across, gets the pass. Can he get to the first down marker? I believe he has it. And that is Citizen Kane Stevenson.
Pete, that's just pure determination and putting your nose down. Of course, he's a veteran here in this team.
So it's first and goal, Sean, the ball at the 8-yard line.
And Pete, what a great effort you saw on the play there.
All right, here
with Stevenson.
Boy, he's had a couple of big plays, hasn't he? We thought he was down, and he said, hey, don't give up on me that quickly, guys. And we won't anymore, said it's Kane.
And you can see he goes to the bench, and boy, they... Sorry, I got the wrong number, but what an effort by him. Those are two big yards.
All right, lots of motion. Stevenson heading to the left side. Abood has the ball turned, hands it off, running up the middle, and getting all the way to the 1 yard line. Oh, they're looking for touchdown. But what a run there by
Mason
number 32,
Duvall.
Mason Duvall.
That knee was down, unfortunately.
Yeah. Well, I got to believe, Sean, if you got to go for it, because, you know, if it does get to third down.
For sure.
You're down 14-3, and you got the ball down here, and you're going to force that offense to go 90, 100.
Pete, this is where you missed old Isaiah Smith.
Yeah, no question. I'm surprised they don't have McCray. Well,
they
McCray's
do.
In
McCray's
there, but
in.
I thought he might be right up under center, but no, they're going to stand him in the shotgun. Here we go, the turn and the handoff. No, the fake handoff, and he'll waltz in. And that's the Marshall, the new Marshall in town. Marshall McCray, touchdown Griffin. What a play fake to Duvall.
Boy, Pete, and you have to believe they have someone spying on him.
Oh, man.
But he is just really hard to get down in the open field. And
watch this, folks. Watch this fake. What a great fake to Duvall. Pulled three linebackers and walked in untouched. All right. Number 70, Gabriel Canabrava. He's going to kick the extra point. Down, up, good. And the score, with 2 minutes to go here in the first quarter, is the Laurier Golden Hawks 14, the Guelph Gryphons 10. And if you wanted to see offense, you're in the right building, Sean.
And Pete, we talked before the game, and I had said that I thought it might be a low-scoring game. And what I meant by that, a low-scoring game in the first quarter only. But all types of excitement here. But let's face it, Guelph has got to find a way to stop Ergasma immediately.
Yeah, without question. Well, listen, John, we've got to give a shout-out to Jeremy Parkinson and Nick Oakley, who normally follow us from Calgary. And here they are live at the stadium. Had a great conversation with them. Thanks, guys, for following us on Twitter and following us on OUA and Rogers TV. Now.
Well, they love that one call of yours. In fact, their week is not complete.
Yeah, I hope I get to say it.
I know. The old.
We have fun. Good play there by 52.
Absolutely. That's Larry Yunus. Yeah, he made a nice play. And here comes Ergasma. And that.
Four receivers to the right, Sean. Back to pass. Looking. Throws it across the middle. No surprise. It's number four. But how about my namesake? Number 55, Jack Cobb, making a hit. Well done.
Well, Jack Cobb starting today in the middle there, Pete. And Braden Farrigo.
Hurt. There he is. Good shot on number 55. COBB. All right, big play. Second down and five. Lots of motion. Ogersma back, throws it long and deep. Got a man open, and it is caught. What a pass right on the sideline. The ball caught around the 53-yard line by Thorne.
Raiden Thorne again. Yeah.
Look at this pass, folks. Just snaps it out there on a rope. He can't draw it up any better.
Yeah, Jordan going underneath and Thorne looping to the outside. That's happened twice now.
Lafourcade with the hit, number three. Had a nice chat with him before the game. Lots of motion. Here's the turn. Fakes the handoff. Throwing it out. We've seen this play before. And making it kind of a saving tackle out there.
I think that's Guthrie. Anakin Guthrie.
Yeah, Anakin Skywalker Guthrie. Because if he does
not,
he's going to go much farther. So he's allowed it to be second and five instead of another first down. Look at that. Diving for the angles and managing to get a few more yards.
I'll tell you, Pete, they never used a ton in this offense.
All right,
number four.
Yeah, Todd Galloway, if you're good, he's going to find you. That's for darn sure. The offensive coordinator, lots of time. Throws it right there across the middle. He's going to have a first down. That looks like number 14, Quentin Scott, Sean. Coming out of the backfield. Is the first down.
He usually carries the ball, Pete, but this multifaceted offense there. And we mentioned it earlier. Absolutely surgical at times. Again, no pressure on him.
Last play of the first quarter here. First down, ball at the takes the handoff again, throwing out there in the flat, getting another first down. Looks like number 88.
Pete, and that's Ryan Spite again.
Yeah. He's kept passing. It's really like pitch and catch right now. You can see all kinds of time. Rolls to his right. Wide open out there. Guthrie having to run him out of bounds. That's the end of the first quarter, Sean, and the score. The Laurier Golden Hawks 14 and Guelph Gryphons 10, but the Golden Hawks are threatening again.
While we have a break today, let's talk about USports top 10.
Right.
Number one, maybe no surprise to anyone, Laval. Number two, Western, followed by Saskatchewan at number three. Number four is Montreal. Number five, Santa Fe. Good for them. These Laurier Golden Hawks, 2-0, vaulted into the sixth spot. Queens at seven, followed by Ottawa, UBC, and it's really nice to see the Windsor Lancers with two big victories coming as number 10 in the country.
Well, that's my alma mater, and I like to see the Jet do well, except when they're playing us. And, they played us last week and thrashed us pretty good down there. And, they're good, and it's going to be interesting. They've got, I think, when Guelph plays York, which is our homecoming,
interesting test. Couldn't help but notice a lot more Americans on that in that Windsor lineup. I know in the past there hasn't been many, but there just seems to be a new vibe and a new energy down in Windsor Town.
Lots of people, movement coming in and out of that Guelph lineup. Taylor Algersma. Three receivers to the right, a big, look at all the linemen in, and only one setback. And there's the fake handoff, and looking, throwing it long and deep, got a man open, and it's caught! Touchdown! Oh my goodness, is that number 18?
That's 18, Pete, Raiden Thorne, that's
boy,
his second one.
What a perfectly thrown ball, because I'm gonna tell you, watch the replay, he's well covered, Sean.
Well, Pete, the DB just, not
didn't
aware that this ball is in the
yeah.
air.
Didn't turn to find the ball. Look, folks, right there.
And that
was
is
Slaughter.
Slaughter, and Slaughter wasn't aware that ball was up.
21-10.
Boy, Guelph is just going to have to find a way to make some stops here on defense, Pete.
Yeah, without question. They've had the ball three times, Laurier, and have three touchdowns to show. And trying to add on the extra point here. The kick is up. It is good. And as I mentioned, with 14:39 to go, the Golden Hawks lead 21-10. The Gryphons are going to have to slug back, Sean. Look at that berm across the way filling up with people. That is wonderful. And hey, we've got to give a shout out because this is a week, and it hasn't happened in a while, where we brought Virginia Moynihan and Patty Cobb along for the ride. Our wives are here at the game today. So we got to be on our best behavior.
Well, Pete, we got in some trouble on the way down when I informed the girls there's no talking in the car.
We'll talk
Pete
football
and I will be talking prep. Football and preparing. And, I mean, that didn't go over well.
No, no. Well, Jenny gave you a kind of one of those knuckle wraps. See, there are no red marks in the back of your head.
Yeah. Anyway, it's great to have them here.
It is. They enjoy
they do
enjoy
love
sports.
The environment coming here.
They'll tune us in once in a while, just like you folks are. And we thank Rogers and OUA TV for allowing us to broadcast this in. And number 22, Dawson Hodge, is going to get ready to blast it to Genesis or Guthrie, I believe. Or maybe, yeah, looks like, well, maybe not. Let's see. That's 17.
They're going to Guthrie this time.
That's Wilton, yeah, for 37. Anakin Guthrie, and he got hit hard there.
Let's get a number on that tackle because he tracked him down from behind. Number 30, I believe, Brady Linehart. And what
that's
a
it.
Tackle. And he catches up to him from behind.
Ooh, man, number 88. Tight. Wait, we call his name. He seems to be around the ball. Offense. All right, here we go, John. First down, ball at the 14-yard line. Long ways to go, but let's see if these Gryphons can have another extended touchdown drive. Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Bit of motion now coming out here to Abood's left. Takes the handoff, rolls to the right, throws long and deep, got Genesis open, and oh, he turned back. Both ways, he was open.
He turned the wrong way initially and couldn't adjust to the ball. You gotta like this play, though. Stretch it out.
Watch the boot roll out here to the right. He's got pressure there and throws off 1 foot, and that ball, that's a good pass, John, because he had the defender beat there. All right, big key
and
play here.
Pete, we talked, they just have to find Vishon as much as possible. He's great speed. He's a vet here on this team, a real team leader.
Okay, second down. Stevenson moving into the slot. Back to pass. And we have a whistle. Is there a delay?
Could be time.
Looks like maybe a delay of game. Yep, that's what it is.
That makes it second down. 15.
Yeah, this is your home field, too. You know, you have to do 20 seconds.
Well, anyhow. Problem with this, Pete, is you're on your own nine, and at the way things are going, you can't be punting the ball out of your own end zone here.
Second and 15. Good shot of Coach Jay, and those kind of penalties would drive a coach nuts. Abood again looking back to pass, got some time, steps up in the pocket, steps up again, now he's going to try to run, and he's brought down. And you know, probably not a bad idea to throw that ball.
Pete, everyone covered, couldn't find a man, and him eating it there is likely the right play.
Yeah, you can see he's looking, and he steps up again, and a fine tackle there. Like number 52, he's Gregorson. Gregorson made the play. Golden Hawks are going to get what they wanted, forcing the Gryphons to punt from their own end zone. And you can see the two men back for the Golden Hawks, and here they're going to give up a single. Safety, my apologies, a 2-point. No rouge there. I got Murray Drinkwater. You know, he's going to correct me here, too. That voice you heard in the background is the legendary Murray Drinkwater. And we are going to talk about Sean. His incredible performance at Buffalo Wild Wings five years ago.
They ran out of the boneless chicken wings. I got there late. Can I get 2 pounds of boneless chicken wings, medium sauce? Sorry, Murray's been here for an hour.
Well, and you know, when he left town, it closed down.
Well,
so that shows you.
My guess is it was following him. That's
they opened up an extra one in Murray's hometown. I love it. he's the greatest. We love him. He gives
us some great insights.
He really does. Okay, here come the Golden Hawks. There's the handoff running up the middle and gaining. Oh, still bubbling for yards there. My goodness. They had him 3 yards back. And that is number 14 again, Quint Scott. This is an impressive run. Watch this. The first guy really tried to have. Hold on, that was 39 for extra. Had him, but just couldn't bring him down. Well, look at the thighs. Tree trunks.
El Khadi eventually wrapped him up, but second and short.
Second and one.
Burgess must be
changing the play at the line of scrimmage. Back to pass, looking. Throwing out into the flat again. And again, throwing down for a first down. Number 39, Johnny Green. But he's seen enough of Quint so far.
Just great patience. Algersmont, game feed, as you can see. He's just got so much time.
See, that's the fifth.
And he just dumps that off after nothing open downfield.
All right, Algersmont throws out again to the slot. He's got Jordan. Jordan makes one man miss and is brought down after another gain of about 8 yards.
And Pete, this has really become a significant first down play again. 37 and 8, every first down play. Hitting Jordan out in the flat. And grabs a couple extra.
All right, second down and about 4 receivers to the right now. The motion, a little bit of it coming to the left. Looks like a little fake inside handoff. And again, that little slot pass being knocked out of bounds is number 10, Jackson Steddings.
And Pete, I think that was Miles that made that tackle on the outside. Let's check our numbers. Yep, number three.
And boy, this play where you fake the handoff and hit your receiver flat, we have seen it a ton. It looks like we got some cramp issues here with one of the Gryphons. We have a slight delay. And Sean, I know at some time today we're going to talk. We had a great talk with a former special teams coach. And he talked about a number of the initiatives that are going on.
Yeah, I had a good chat with Billy Brown, and Bill was telling us about, you know, in the far end zone here, Pete, Friends of Griffin Football, and it's, boy, a great program they offer here. And, you know, this year alone, that group has generated $30,000 in scholarship monies. In the last 4 years, they've done $100,000 in scholarship.
Incredible.
And Friends of Guelph Football, very impressive. And, boy, they've got Harvey's involved. Wow. Harvey's was giving away 1,000 free hamburgers.
I saw you try to get in line three
times. I was trying to get one for Murray. And anyways, they're giving away 1,000 free hamburgers today. And I think they're handing out another 3,000 coupons for free hamburgers.
We had the chicken, and it was delicious. Oh. The pop people.
Yep. Parents of players party today.
Tremendous.
Hot dogs. You know, it was outstanding. But this Friends of Guelph Football, how impressive. I know Stu Ling is, of course, instrumental in it. Here we go back to football, Pete.
All right, Algersma turns, hands the ball off, and running wild. And look out. There goes Scott. He's all the way down to the 14-yard line. Off tackle. Untouched until about the 15-yard line.
And this Laurier offense, Pete, just churning on all cylinders now. Boy, big pull off tackle, as you said.
Boy,
Cromwell.
You've got to have courage. Who made that tackle, like Cromwell?
Well, that's 21, Pete. That's Malcolm James, the free safety.
Yeah.
Saving a touchdown there.
Yeah, you don't want your free safety making too many tackles. That means it's way down the field. It's first down, ball on the 11-yard line. Run that little offensive fake. Here we go, hand off again, up the middle. Gaining about 4, maybe 5 yards there as number two, Tanner Nelms.
I'm trying to get the tackle there, Pete. I think it was El Qadi, number 44, in the thick of that.
55, my man. Jack Cobb. All right, second down at five. Got a little bit of a delay. Do we have a timeout here, maybe? Like Elker's mother, might have been some kind of illegal substitution. And now a discussion here between Eric, how do you pronounce that, Murray? Gebby.
Shredded tires.
Paul Duncan, let's see what the verdict is. Nobody's worse for wear. All right, second down then. So the Hawks can get a first down if they get it to the 2-yard line. Elgersma with three receivers to the right. Back to pass. Got all kinds of time. Going to roll out. Throw into the end zone. Got a man open. Touchdown! Ethan Jordan, number 4, folks. The kid from the Maple City making it happen again.
Boy.
Oh, we got a holding on the offense, so bring it back. Boy, that's a huge call.
I was just about to say, all types of time. Either Algersma there, Pete. He gets such a good look. I didn't quite catch the hole, but with that amount of time.
Something's got to be going on somewhere. Anyhow, this is going to make things interesting. It's now second down, and they've got to get down to the 2-yard line. So second and 14 or 15 here to acquire a first down. Let's see what the call is. A single coverage out here, far right. Jordan is out in the slot. Number 4 here to the right. Good shot of Algersma. Here's the turn, fakes the handoff, looking. Gonna step up in the pocket, throw over the shoulder, and it's caught! Touchdown! Oh my goodness. And again, excellent coverage there by number 3, Miles Lapicade, but he had his back to the ball.
Just didn't realize the ball was in the air. And Pete, number 11. We're going to get a pronunciation of this game. We're not going to.
Laomi is the first name. Ojutek Lyo. Laomi Ojutek Lyo. Going to get that shot. But he caught the ball for the touchdown, and that makes it 29-10. And the Laurier Golden Hawks are flexing their muscles here as they go for the extra point. It's down. The kick is up. It's good. We got a flag on the play. And let's see if that is going to be offside on the defense. Yep. Okay, so will that 5 yards be assessed on the kickoff? And it will. I'm learning the rules here. Murray's giving me a B minus so far.
Yeah, all right. After the Buffalo Wild Wings comment, I'm surprised he's,
Look at that good shot of Coach Shane. Look at the hands on the hips, and
we had a nice chat with him, Pete, before the game. He's always so generous.
Oh, he was all business.
But he was all business today.
He was.
And he was not happy about last week and wanted to improve on that. But he's a little concerned about his defense right now, Pete.
The arms folded and, it's tough. It's tough when you're trying to reestablish. They've got a lot of youth on this team. You're going to have some growing pains. And unfortunately, Sean, you're going to take your lumps while those growing pains are happening. You're dealing with a football club for the Laurier Golden Hawks. Coach Falls, he thinks they're going to be very competitive. Well, they're looking very competitive
for sure, Pete.
They play the Western Mustangs this year, and that's going to be another
I think the final game on the...
Yeah. It could be for all the marbles. Here's the kickoff deep into the end zone. Guthrie's going to bring it out. He's going to fake to the left and then come back to the right, make a nice move, get to the outside, and a nice... And we have a flag thrown late. Anakin Skywalker Guthrie got the ball out to the 25-yard line. Let's see what the flag is.
Tackle by Dawson Hodge there, Pete.
Kicker.
Here's the move, Pete. He makes a nifty
little
move
right there. The kicker. 22, special team. Kicker puts his shoulder in there. They always get teeth on the kicker. Lots of discussion here. You can see Kevin Baird. We've got Paul Duncan. Richard Book is the down judge. Side judge is Bill Degetti, you say. Back judge is Darren Cochran. Field judge is Dave Potitz. Supervisor is the great driver.
Boy, Pete, here we go. Oh. Penalty on Guelph. I didn't quite catch the call, but.
Oh, illegal participation. He came out of bounds and then came back inbounds. Can't do that. All right. Three receivers to the left. Abood surveys the situation. Tall mountain to climb now, down 20. Fakes the handoff. Abood looks, throws it out in the slot. Got a man open again. That's Arsenal. He's had a good game today. Willem Arsenal opens downfield.
First-year kid from Calgary, Pete.
I'm impressed with Abood. He's comfortable back there.
Been great
got
today,
time.
Pete.
He really has.
Starts beating his own end.
That good shot, head up, stops, sets his feet, throws it. Arsenal wide open again, a fine tackle, but a first down out at the 30 and a half yard line. Here come the Gryphons. Stevenson going in motion to the right. Abood back to pass, steps up, and is going to be brought down from behind. And you can see they kind of doing a little duck walk there.
Matt Caruso.
Yeah.
With the sack.
Three on the play. It's going to be second and 13. So another key offensive play here for these Gryphons with 7:25 to go before halftime. Abood back to pass. He's got some time. He's looking. He throws it at the sideline. It's caught! And what a nice catch at Pitts there. And is that Genesis?
It's
it is.
Bichon.
First down. And boy, got to get him involved, and there he comes out with a big first down.
Another great pass by Tristan Aboud. Yeah. Lots of time.
Great job offensive line. Genesis. And the ball all the way out to their 49-yard line. First down. Four receivers here to the near side, Sean. Lots of motion. Here's the turn. That's McCray, little pitch to Malloy. Malloy's got 8, 9, maybe 10 yards and maybe another first down. Oh, he's gonna be a yard short. And nice play.
They slid him in with no one really noticing.
I looked down at my notes for a second and the marshal's there. And nice pitch play to Malloy. And he gets, there's nobody out on the edge. He's gonna gain 9 yards. And all of a sudden, the football is moved into Laurier territory. Gray in there again. He's going to be right under center. They need a yard for the first down. He's going to run off tackle. He's got more as he gets to the outside, fakes, and gets that first down. Good play there by number one.
Oh, yeah. Io Ajayi made a nice open field tackle.
Very solid Io. First down Gryphons, so as they move the ball now to the 48-yard line of the Golden Hawks, 5:39 and counting
Marshall
to go.
Marshall McCray, he loves to get outside, doesn't
he? Yes, he does.
And we have seen him throw the ball too, Pete, so look for that later in this contest.
Aboud steps up and gets hit, moves to the outside, and look out, he's hit from front and back. And it takes a loss of 4 on the play.
He's got to throw that ball away there, Pete. Looks like no one, you know, open in the flat there for him to get it to.
And he wanted the quick hitter, and number 20 came in with his hand. Duncan Naughty came in with his hands up.
Naughty needed to hit number 22.
Shot of the defensive coordinator.
Second and 15, Pete, on that loss.
All right. Three receivers to the left, two to the right, one setback. Malloy, Aboud surveys the situation, back to pass, steps up, looks, rolls out here to the left, got a little bit of time, and he's going to try to hit. He gets hit hard. He's really wanting his receiver to come back to the ball. See a little frustration there with Tristan.
Absolutely, Pete. And I know we don't like holding the ball here, but again, maybe the best decision.
Yeah, he's looking, look, he's looking downfield and then realizes, no, I gotta, he can see, he gets up, come on, he gotta come back to the quarterback on a broken play. Anything, comes a punt. Seen a lot of punts today. Kind of a pooch kick.
Barely got it off, Pete, and a tough.
See everybody getting out of the way and flags all over the place. That'll be a 5-yarder.
Yeah, Pete, when that ball bounces back too, eh? It's just trouble.
Gardero, 49, was the punter trying to get down on that ball.
Well, that would have been an interesting play.
Yeah. See, there he is. Gardero made the tackle.
That ball, Peter.
Denver Beasley. Flag. Oh, the media flag. Going down the field to see what the contest is. Uh-oh, Sean, one of your favorites. Where you got to chase the gopher.
Oh, my.
The gopher, and look at him turn it on. He's got to be a sprinter. Oh my goodness gracious! I think Coach Shane's going over there to sign that kid up.
Well, you know, the track team here at Guelph is outstanding. They snuck in a 200 yard man, I'm sure. There, Guelph needs to stop. They've not stopped all day, and they really need a stop on defense.
had him a couple of times. Second and long.
But the key has been Taylor. Calgary's won on all types of time. He has shown such poise.
That's an excellent poise. Experienced quarterback. Coach Galloway sang his praises, didn't he?
Oh, for sure.
Here's a little flip fake handoff. Number 11's got the ball, and he gets to the outside, breaks a couple of tackles, has got a first down, and that is Laomi Ajutalea.
Talk about Nathaniel Slaughter. Slaughter, first year.
Ajutalea. Ajutalea.
Tackle.
There he
great
is right
speed.
There. Ajutalea. Out wide right here. Golden Hawks have a 20-point lead. They got the ball, and there's 3 minutes and 30 seconds to go before halftime. There's the handoff, and good defensive play there. That's
Quentin Scott right up the middle, but
Woodmansey
makes
play.
The big man made a play.
Curtis Woodmansey, number 98. Watch this, folks. Scott's a big kid to bring down, but
oh,
look at Woodmansey.
What a play. Number 98.
Now here's the play right here. This is key. Second and long. Second down and 8. They might try that little flat play that's worked out a lot for them. You can see Elgersma really
directing traffic.
Yeah, exactly. Making
look
sure
out
the
for number.
Game. Here comes the blitz from the outside. The ball is thrown. It's caught. Going to be short of a first down. Good defensive play there. Is that Guthrie on the tackle?
That's Guthrie. And you can see what they were trying to do there. They wanted Ojateo matched up against Guthrie, and Guthrie really
yeah.
made the big play there.
He did. And now
Coach Fultz choosing to turn the field over here, Pete.
Well, what a
beauty.
Way back, fielding in his own two. Guthrie cuts one way and then back to Miller, and he's brought down immediately. Good. Is that Spite again, number 88?
Ryan Spite.
Oh, my goodness. What a game he's had on special teams. And made one nice catch on offense.
And this special teams of Laurier look so quick. And take a look at this, everyone.
Wow.
Guthrie yeah. really no room to move. Big boy.
He is.
He's made a couple key tackles on special teams.
All right, here comes the Gryphon offense, Sean, and they're backed up again, their own 7-yard line. But wouldn't it be something for her 2 minutes and 24 seconds? They roll that ball down and cut into this lead.
Would be big, Pete.
Oh, I see Murray ordered the pizza and it showed up on time. My goodness.
Well,
thank you to the good people at Domino's.
Yep.
And no, is that, that's the great Andy Beckler, ladies and gentlemen.
Here we go, Pete.
Back to pass roll is caught, brought to the outside, and that's number 19.
That's Craig Sherrington, his first action today.
Yeah. Nice little gain there. It's going to be second down, and nope, they moved it back. Second and 8, so gain of 2. And a critical play here with 2:20 to go. Now you can see why Coach Falls has great confidence in his defense. He's got these Gryphons in second and long again. All right. Abood looking to his left and to his right. Here comes Kane Stevenson in motion. Abood back to pass, looking. Throwing it long and deep out there to Arsenal, and it is
off
his
hands.
With good coverage out there, but he was open for a moment. And now it's going to be punt time. But boy, that was a 42-yard pass in the air by Abood. Maybe farther. Look at that. Perfect technique. Oh, that might have been
foot.
A catchable football, Sean.
Sure
got
his
got
hands
a hand on
that.
Yeah.
That's Dawson Hodge. He's had a great, great first half, too, for Laurier.
Okay, looks like maybe going to take another knee and give up a deuce. And that now makes it 32-10 with 1:52 to go. And we're going to see... Taylor Elgersma bring this offense back out. See what he can do with his 2 minute offense. John, you think, again, the West Husker Mustangs look like they're a powerhouse again. It's maybe it's fortunate they're not on the Guelph Gryphons schedule. The Gryphons got some tough games ahead of them still, you know.
We'll talk about Western after this, right after this play, Peter. But here comes Laurier again.
Ogersma back to pass, looking, throws the ball across the middle. It's caught, first down, and brought down there by number 43, Braden McDougal. Quick first down there. Ball was caught by number 10, Jackson Stebbings.
Stebbings, I think, first action of the day. He's on this stat sheet.
A little bit of confusion when the players are going to line up. Number 11 way out there. So there's three out there to the left, two to the right, one set back. There's the handoff. No, the fake. There's that flat play again. And coming up and hitting, but not wrapping up. And that allowed the Laurier player.
Gee, that allowed number, I have
83.
Oh, 83, yeah. Okay.
Jace Atkinson.
It looked like he was going to be crushed. And
it's important you wrap up. You see a couple of guys come in and just throw shoulders. No, you got to wrap these guys up. Second down and two. There's the fake handoff, the flat play. Now the loop out pass and wide open out here. And trailed down about the 22-yard line is Thorne. Thorne has had a big game. He's got a touchdown.
He has been a thorn in the side of Guelph. And again, they use.
What's the fake flat now
Ethan
when
Jordan,
those guys come
Ethan
up?
Ethan Jordan in the flat again that they're focusing on, and what touch?
Nicholas Parchenko down on. See, is 1:10 to go, and all of a sudden the ball is situated at the 12, 22-yard line. So three quick plays, and the Laurier Golden Hawks, Sean, are knocking on the door again. They lead it 32-10.
Pete, we were just talking about Western a few minutes ago. You know, last weekend, Mac came into to Western. Mac, after losing the week before to Windsor, came in and lost 34-22 to Western. Very close game. Big interception for a touchdown near the end of that game by Western over Mac, but that was a close game. And I know just reading some of the papers this week and other broadcasts, boy, Western was not happy with their play. And kudos to Mac for going in there and really giving them quite a game. I believe Western goes to Queens. I believe Laurier finishes the year at Western. And I think Guelph was on the road that day, that last game of the year. I think they're in Ottawa, if my memory serves me right. And I might just go to that Western and Laurier game. I might put on my Guelph gear and stroll in.
Coach Faulds could get you those VIP tickets. Or Coach Marshall, one or the other. They're always, both of them are very kind to us. All right, back to pass. Looking, got all kinds of time. Throwing that ball across the middle and just over the hands of Ethan Jordan, but you cannot give Taylor Elgersma that kind of time. Second and long.
Well, he has Jordan here. Again, lots of time and great patience and just
overthrown. Ethan Jordan can fly, I'll tell you.
Look at great in Canadian football, Pete, the size of the end.
Oh, yeah.
I just find NFL and American football, that small end zone. It's great here in the Canadian rules.
Hey, back to pass, four receivers to the right, ball thrown in a middle. Touchdown, Laurier. And that looked like number 83, Jace Atkinson. And boy, second and long, and again, a beautifully thrown pass by Elgersma. That extends the lead to 38, looking to try to make it 39. The extra point by Dawson Hodge awaiting.
Boy, that almost was too easy for just all types of room there, and what a bullet. And number
ball
13.
Down, kick is up, it is good, and that does make it 39-10 with just under a minute to go. All right, Mr. Moynihan, I'm going to ask you to put your coaching hat on. What's the message in the locker room at halftime by Coach Shea?
They've just got to find more pressure on the quarterback. They got to, I don't know if they got to send a linebacker or whatever, but Elgersma's got so much time. He is so smooth. And it's an impressive performance, but just appears that, especially that secondary right now, Guelph is just overmatched.
Yeah.
I know number 22, Devin Cromwell, is just a fantastic player here, Pete. And they just, they're not even going near him.
Yeah.
Elgersma's got this worked out beautifully.
Well, and without the human torpedo, too, boy,
yeah.
It's amazing what one player, the difference one player can make.
Well, and Farrago, too, in the middle,
yeah,
they're
yeah.
missing, which is, and yeah. Scott Murray, fantastic defensive lineman, first team OUA last year. He's out with an injury. I believe it's a shoulder injury, too. They hope to get him back, but missing some key parts. And
all right, here's Hodge with the kickoff, and it's caught, scooped up by Guthrie. He tries to cut, makes one man miss, gets another 2, 3, 4 yards, and does have the ball up to the 25-yard line. Decent field possession, position, I should say, for these Guelph Gryphons.
Sebastian Parsadillas made the tackle there, Pete.
Well, it's going to be important here. There's 49.8 seconds to go. You want to get a first down or two, because you do not want to give that offense the ball again. The defense is worn out.
I don't think Laurier has used the timeout yet.
No, I agree.
So they may get...
No, they got all three. Both teams have all three. All right, Abood with all kinds of motions from the receivers. He's back to pass. He's looking, throws the ball into the flat. It's caught. Good play there. And making one man miss, and oh, being brought down as number 23, Donovan Malloy. Nice little run, pitch catch, and that's a big first down, getting the ball out to the 45-yard line. Good play by Abu. Watch him look downfield, fake, and then find that Malloy out of the backfield. Looking a lot like Jahmyr Gibbs. Sorry, another Detroit Lion reference there, Sean.
Nico.
Here's the fake handoff. No, it's not a fake. Malloy has the ball up near mid, almost to the 50-yard line.
Guelph takes a timeout, Pete.
29.9 seconds to go. Oh, it doesn't look like the timeout. They're going to get right back at it here. Second down and 5, a key play for this offense. Back, a little bit of pressure. Here's the throw, and it is caught! And that looks like it's going to be good enough. That's Arsenal again. Had a nice game.
Keaton Guelph got away with a hold there. You
see
can
that.
See the jersey.
I did see that.
You can see the jersey reach over here on the side.
Yeah.
But Guelph will take it, and Arsenal
get the first down, and the score 39-10 for the Golden Hawks. 22.2 seconds to go, and Sean, okay, I got a moment. Thursday night. How late did you stay up? I celebrated till 2 in the morning when we beat the Kansas City Chiefs.
We're big Detroit Lion fans and like to get over for a game every year. This year we won't. I mean, it's going to be impossible to get tickets.
Oh, my goodness.
Detroit is now, you know, they're awake now. And, yeah, it was a fantastic finish and just a fantastic effort. You got to love that head coach, Dan. But that's... Let's have a Jared Goff touchdown throw right here by
Tristan Abood. I gotcha. Maybe to Amon Ross St. Brown. Okay, here we go. Abood back to pass. Blitz coming from the side. Thrown out. It's caught by Genesis. He gets misses on one man miss. Look at that fake. What a fake by Genesis. And he's out of bounds at the 25-yard line. We got a flag on the play.
Pete, it's a late hit. Laurier player. I can't quite see the number.
Kevin Baird going to let us know.
Look,
yes, it
move.
Is. What Look. A move there. I'm going to tell you.
Yeah, it was number
Sean
20,
Genesis.
Pete, Duncan Naughty. You know, Pete, with 12 seconds to go, that's just a terrible penalty to take.
Boy, look at here, Sean, they are knocking on the door. The ball's at the 12-yard line.
Well, Pete,
Guelph Gryphons.
What do you
two
think? Let's go to the end zone twice here, Pete.
Right on. Abood, two receivers to the left, two to the right. One setback, looking, throwing it into the middle. It is, knocked down. It was just a little high, I think. Again, looking for Genesis. You can see,
I think thought he was going over the top to 14, which is Ryan Ogilvy.
28 was there, so I'm glad it didn't make it. Boteazor was waiting patiently.
In the middle, number three, Nico McCarthy. What a game he has had. He is all over the place, and here we go, second and goal.
Watch the ball!
Of the 12-yard line. Abood back to pass looking. Stepped up in the pocket. He's going to run it. He's got some room. Look at him bust. Did he get in? Let's see. No, he's down at the 1-yard line. And, oh, we got a flag and a holding call, and you can see
Brandon Amanuwa's.
Yeah, signaling, hey, it's a holding call.
Giving the officials a little bit of a hand out there.
So 2.4 seconds left. It looks like you might have to kick a field goal here, Sean. Yeah, and that's what they're going to do. And we will see number 70, Gabriel Canabrava. Try to split the uprights. About, I'm going to say 28 yards. See, kind of a good way to go into the half, at least getting some points in that short period of time, 50 seconds. Now down to 2.4. Here we go. Ball is down. The kick is up, and it is good. And so with the halftime score, it makes it the Laurier Golden Hawks 39, the Guelph Gryphons 13. And Mr. Moynihan, I guess we'll have lots to reflect upon over halftime.
Yeah.
All right. Now, again, I put you on the spot about what's the message at halftime. We got to get pressure on Elgersma.
You know, offensively, Pete, this team is, Guelph has looked good. And Abood has shown, he has shown great poise for a first-year kid. But boy, the secondary has been absolutely torched. Now, maybe unfair to say the secondary because they're not getting much pressure up front. But, I mean, this Taylor Algersma is all that's been reported.
And Ethan Jordan Thorne. Boy, what a 1-2 punch they've got. Wide receiver.
And, you know, they roll that Ethan Jordan out into the flat all the time, draw the man, throw it over top of him. We've seen it really nonstop. Graydon Thorne, I think he had 2 touchdown passes. We'll get some stats. Also Pete, today.
All right, let's head down to Scotty Fraser.
Protected or protected and had too much time in the pocket. And that's really what has burned you. 39-13 doesn't tell the whole story. How do you get on him in the second half and kind of take that time and space away?
Well, he's an experienced player with a good offensive line in front of him, no question. Obviously, you know, he's playing like the guy I expected him to, you know, fresh off the Toronto Argos experience that he had. Good quarterback play usually translates out to good offense. But, you know, what happened in the first half wasn't necessarily all about him. It was a lot of things about us. You know, we had some guys that didn't track through coverage, you know, and we made some mistakes offensively too. So where it looked like it was going to be a little bit of a shootout for a while, we kind of slipped up and then, you know, put the defense back on the field really fast. So we just need to tighten up and come back out here and play football. We're still a young football team with young quarterbacks. So let's see how much we can accomplish in 30 minutes and see what the next half brings us.
How much can you use this crowd to get your team going in the second half?
Well, you know, it feels like Guelph is back today. You know, the students on the hill, the alumni and the parents in the stands. This is always one of the great ballparks to play in. So we'll sharpen up. We'll bring it forward in 30 minutes.
Appreciate the time. Best of luck in the second half.
Thanks, Scott.
And we'll send it over to the desk with Madupe and Dunk standing by. Guys.
Folks, and welcome back to the Gryphvision Halftime Show. The score right now is the Golden Hawks 39 to the Guelph Gryphons 13. Not the strongest start for Guelph right now, but there's still plenty of ball game to be played here. So let's talk a little bit about the first half and how Laurier's veteran team is playing right now. Yeah. Absolutely. absolutely. And Guelph, what have they done so far to like stand out for you? What have, how have they been playing so far? So, in your opinion, Justin, is experience playing a factor in today's game? Yeah. Yeah. Absolutely. Thank you. I'm just going to throw it to our third member of our team, Scotty Fraser, who's down on the field now with Keandre Smith.
A kind of coming home experience for you this evening or this afternoon. This team maybe not putting on the best show so far, but you've spent 2 years in the CFL now. What's it like to be back here as a former Gryphon?
It's always good to be back here. It always feels like home every out here. The environment's still good. Still packing the stands. So there's always hope, and you always got to be ready to come back in the second half and just recover.
And you went through your rookie year in the CFL now in that sophomore season. How have you settled in as not just a player, but as a man, as a pro?
Honestly, it's just a level of maturity. It's just being surrounded by people who have fully like-minded goals, who are really putting all their time into something. It allows you all to get on the same page and really just focus up. So it lets the maturity really build.
Your father played a long time in the CFL as well. How much do you lean on him for that experience and the growing pains that every single pro goes through?
He's a great mentor and he's a great mind. He's a great football mind. So it's always good to lean on him whenever I have the opportunity. But other than that, he's another dad supporting his son, right?
I understand that. And lots of dads, friends, and family out here for the O-Week game. Guelph, again, not quite showing that offensive prowess they once had with you on the field. To you, as Keandre Smith, what do you think that Guelph needs to change in this second half to get that killer instinct and get some touchdowns here?
Every guy just has to find their identity and do their 112. There's 12 men on the field. Every man has their own job, right? So if everyone does their 112, you have a whole, and you guys have a whole unit that works cohesively together, right? So it's just finding your role and doing the best you can in your role and winning your own individual matchups, and then you have team success that way.
We appreciate the time and welcome home. Go enjoy the rest of the game, okay?
Of course. Thank you, boss.
No problem. And we are going to take a quick break and be back with more of our Gryphon Halftime Show. Stay with us.
Can you guys hear me now, Jeff, on the Scott's mic? Check, check. Looks like a pro, and sometimes you have guys that get drafted and they play in the CFL or the NFL and you're like, I know he looks a little bit too small, but Keandre looks legit. He's made some plays coming along in his career for the Tiger Cats, who have had so much changeover at the quarterback position. Like this year, for example, it was supposed to be Bo Levi Mitchell. He was the guy. They brought him in. They paid him $500,000 to be the quarterback. He gets hurt. Then it was supposed to be Matthew Shields. He gets hurt. He's done for the year. Now they're on their third quarterback in Taylor Powell. And I still think Smith looks pretty good for a guy in his second year. A lot of people out there got to remember, he is the son of Adrian Pee-wee Smith, who was a great for the Toronto Argonauts, won multiple Grey Cups. But you know what's interesting? His dad played defensive back. So I wonder if that's part of how Keandre got so good at receiver, yeah. Because Pee-wee could have been like, you know, this would beat me, this wouldn't. You know what I mean? Get that trash out of here. But Keandre's looked really good as a Gryphon. Now, that's what Guelph's trying to do in this second half, as you see some highlights here. Guelph is trying to get it on track. I think the offense has actually been decent, but the defense has to find a way to get off the field. They need to pressure Taylor Elgersma, who's thrown for four touchdowns in the first half, 288 yards. It's been too easy for him, and there's been some coverage busts in the back end. I know Dennis McPhee, the defensive coordinator, is going to be talking to his group at halftime to clean that stuff up, because I actually think there are reasons to be positive about what Guelph has done on offense. Tristan Abood has moved the football here a little bit. Still a few too many two and outs, but if they're consistent, they can get Donovan Malloy the rock more. He has had a high yards per carry average. Then Guelph can come back in this second half. Some people might look at it and say, well, it's 39-13. Laurier's up big, but that was 30 minutes. We've got a fresh 30 minutes here. Guelph has some reason to be upbeat on offense, and the defense just needs to get some pressure. They have to get after Elgersma, mix up some things, bring some pressure off the edge, give him some different looks so it doesn't look so easy to him in the second half.
Absolutely. So if you have to break it down, what exactly does Guelph have to do in the second half to bring him this way?
Yeah, I think it's very important. Devin Cromwell to play better. I'm going to challenge him right now. We talked about Keandre Smith being a guy in a long line of Gryphons that have gone to the CFL. Mm-hmm. Well, people are talking about Cromwell in that mold, right? We had Searman Harrison Bagayogo go from Guelph to being drafted by the BC Lions, is now in the CFL. Cromwell took over for his spot on that weak side corner spot. So he needs to slow down Thorne. Thorne, we don't want to see him be a thorn in the side of the Gryphons anymore, okay? And that's on, exactly. And that's on Cromwell in this second half, and that veteran side of the defense with Miles Lafourcade as well. Those guys need to step up and play better, but I think that front has to get after the passer. Like, remember in week one, we saw Josh Campbell have some effective plays against the run and even push the pocket against the pass? Well, that's what he needs to do in the second half. We need to see the defensive linemen. Yes, some of these guys are young and inexperienced, but they got to get after the passer. And really, you don't have anything to lose. You're down 26 points.
Yeah.
So let's throw some different looks at him. I'm sure McPhee is going to draw it up to try to get Elgersma a little unsure of what he's seeing from that Guelph defense.
Yeah, absolutely. But again, like we said, there's still plenty of ball game left. So boys, definitely keep your head up high. And you can do this in the second half. If we're talking a little bit more about Gryphon football here, obviously homecoming is coming up in the next couple of weeks. Are we excited for that as well?
Definitely. And Coach Shane talked about it with our Scotty Frazier on the sideline, that it's O-week, the students are here, but homecoming is something totally different, right? You'll have packed stands, and yes, the stands are packed today, but I'm talking about all the way around. The grass will be filled, and homecoming for me always hits home because I played in five homecoming games here, started five. Pretty sure won all five. Maybe there was one loss in there, but a few too many hits to the head. But it's usually a game that you can win. And with York coming in and the way their program looks, it should be a great day for the Gryphons to be able to get a win. I know the team won't say it like that, but you look at what that day can be and what it means to a lot of the alumni as well.
Yeah.
It is a day that hits home for a lot of Gryphons. So if you're watching us and you're a Gryphon alumni, get out to the stadium. There'll be stuff going on all day long.
Exactly.
Come and join us. Be on set with us. We want to talk to the alumni and really see them out there. Friends of Gryphon Football has this big area. We're looking at it right now in the north end zone, if I got my Never Eat Shredded Wheat right in the end zone, the north end zone there. So come out, support your Gryphons, relive some of those memories. And we got the Glory Bowl, right? If you think you could still play, I plan on being here singing around the park a little bit. If you want to come out and play a little bit, I think last year there was a couple guys that had blown hamstrings and stuff, but hey, get healed up. You'll all be good.
We'll take it. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. That's going to do it for us here at the Halftime Show, and we'll be back after the break.
we clear?
The game of his life, four catches, 120 yards, wow, with two touchdowns. Over on the other side, Pete, Tristan Abboud, 10 of 16 for 171 yards. Played pretty good, Tristan Abboud did.
I agree.
And the rookie, the first-year kid, William Arsenal, four catches for 80 yards. Let's see what happens this second half, Pete.
Well, Sean, take a look at this. So under Abboud, he was sacked twice and under pressure. And if you look over at Elgersma, zero sacks and not a lot of pressure. Wasn't really threatened. Every time we talked about him being put in second and long is what you want, he was able to convert. There's a great shot of that kid, number 13. You know the number, remember that name, Taylor Elgersma. He is something. And I thought Coach Galloway, and we're just about ready here, as number 70, Gabriel Canabrava, as the ball blown off the tee. Galloway said, you know what, Pete and Sean, this kid knows more about football than I do. Yeah. That's quite a compliment.
Well, he really spoke to his intelligence, yeah, and his ability to read plays.
And scope the field, and we've witnessed it.
His maturity. And here we go, Pete.
39-13, the Golden Hawks. Here's the kickoff. It is high. It is deep. It's going to be gathered in around the 7-yard line. Coming out here to his left, and good coverage there by those Gryphons as they roll him down. A host of tacklers there.
Led by Ovi Akpanay.
Number 42 also getting in there.
That's
Ovi. Yeah, that's him. Ovi Akpanay. That's a... They don't have his name on the back of the uniform yet, so anyhow,
well,
he was there.
And, folks, I'll tell you, we're up really high.
Yes.
Sometimes it's really difficult to get a number as it's all rolled up. Here comes Laurier.
There's the fake handoff. They're looking. Got time. Throws that across the middle. It's caught. Good defense there. The catch was made by number 83, Chase Atkinson. It's going to be good enough for a first down. But again, Elgersma has time. He had, you know, it was well defended by the Gryphons. But look at the time here, folks. And then, okay, so no, I'm going to go to my third read.
It's just the touch there. Great Dugo, tackle number 43 for Guelph.
First and goal. The ball at first and 10, I should say. The ball at their own 37. Fake handoff, rolling left, and look at, here's the pass out to Jordan. He's open and just off his fingertips, and look at Elgersma hold his head, and Jordan said, oh my, I almost had it. But here we go again, Sean. Second and long.
Need a big defense.
I think we got to dial up some pressure.
Here. You betcha. But look at all types of room. You could park a bus back there, and that missed by inches.
And Anakin Guthrie. All right, folks. Three receivers to the left, two to the right. Only three rushing. So they've dropped an extra linebacker in to help with coverage. And look out, Elgersma's going to take off and run, and he is brought down short of the sticks, I believe. Let's see where they mark it.
Pete, it's going to be really close.
It's all about the mark.
about, from our vantage
about
point,
a yard short,
needs
I think.
To be a yard short.
And here comes the jumbo offense.
Again, great awareness by Ergsma to take that ball.
All right, here we go. It's third and one. You got the I formation, two receivers to the left, jumbo offense. Elgersma steps up, calling the play. Lots of shifting. He's going to roll off the right, make the first down, and brought down.
He likely gained
2 yards.
Oh,
here we got a little pushing green in there, along with number 67 and Tanner Elson. Yeah, you knew there were flags, and it's probably, I'm going to guess, offsetting here. Watch here, folks. Hit, and then Green comes in and kind of just gives a little extra shot right there. And that's where your offensive lineman, and then Green gets up and says, now hold it. And let's see, we've got a discussion here. Kevin Baird, let's see what Kevin has to say.
Well, I think Guelph will take that.
Yes, they will, as they move the ball back. It still will be first down.
You think that's a case, Pete, of the second guy in kind of getting caught, eh?
Yep. So it's going to be first down and 20 now. First and 10. The ball has just moved back to the 41-yard line. There is the handoff, trying to get to the outside, and it's well covered out there. And good defense there by that Griffin.
Quentin Scott trying to
linebacker.
Get outside Pete.
Yeah.
Got him there before. We'll take a look at the replay.
Watch this. It's good penetration right there, 43. You know, even though he fell down, Braden McDougal forced him to go. And Cobb is in on the tackle out there along with 56.
Maxwell Holmes. We have not called Max's name before. Welcome, Max.
Here we go, Sean. Second and long. Second and 8. Ball at their own 43-yard line. The Golden Hawks have the lead and the ball. Elgersma back to pass. 4 rush, and he's going to run again, and he's got the first down. And that's one thing. When you only have 3 rushing and you drop your linebackers in coverage, quarterbacks stay.
I'm still curious, Pete. What do you think Michael Folds and Todd Galloway are thinking? When they see their quarterback take hits that, though.
I would be concerned.
Yeah, sure. Slide or whatever, easy to say from up here, but he's the real deal, and you just can't afford to have him get hurt.
Okay, ball at midfield, Argentina, drop play, and making a move, and what another nice run there by number 14, Quentin Scott. He's had a big game, and he's got another first down, and he's got the ball down to the 43-yard line. Maybe, 43 of the Guelph Gryphons. Look at him go, protecting that football, and down he goes.
Eventually touched by Malcolm James.
First down, Elgersma, who's just putting on a clinic at the QB position here today. Back to pass, looking, throwing out into the flat. Jordan's got all kinds of running room and is brought down.
Looks by like, Lafourcade.
Yeah, and but really, he's able to watch it from the field here. He goes only about 4 yards, turns and said, hey, give me the ball. I got it. Now I'm going to run for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 yards. And another first down. Well, that's just pitch and catch, Sean. We saw this in the first half. And the Golden Hawks are picking up where they left off. 10:43 to go in the third quarter. They got the ball and a 39-13 lead. All right, Elgersma back to pass. There's the screen pass. Scott, what a defensive play there.
Braden McDougal,
goodness.
I believe that was Pete,
it
43.
Was.
He
has
saved serious damage there by getting an arm in.
Sean, let's be honest, he saved a touchdown. Look at the blockers that Scott has in front of him. Folks, this is exceptional defensive play right there. Fight off the block at 66. Tackle at the ankle. Going to be second down and 7. Let's see if another big defensive play can take place here for the Gryphons. 3 receivers to the right, 2 to the left. Back, a little bit of pressure coming. Here's the throw into the end zone. Wide open is Jordan, and touchdown!
Wow.
Oh, my goodness. Anakin Guthrie.
On the coverage
on
there,
the coverage
Pete,
and
but
the tackle. The problem was the tackle was in the end zone.
Just too much room. And
watch this. Back to pass. He's got kind of time. Pitch and catch again. And all of a sudden, it's 45-13 with the possibility of being 46.
And really, Pete, just no answers on defense.
It is good. You know, Sean, I just wonder, and again, you know, you're dealing with a young football club, and after that performance week one against the Varsity Blues, you know, I was thinking, my goodness, like Tristan Abood, it's not on him. Like he is showing that he has football presence.
For sure.
It's unfortunately, the Guelph Gryphon defense is taking its lumps, like we saw last year.
But even game one, we were excited and buoyed by the performance of the defense. As we mentioned earlier, Anthony Mancuso out with an injury right now, unfortunately. Likely had one of the finest defensive games we've seen in the OUA. Just, and you know, an interception and everything, just incredible. And
what a great shot of Taylor Elgersma, you know? He looked like the mighty Thor. Well, he's playing like the mighty Thor.
Well, he's having a game.
He certainly is. Yeah, I met Todd Galloway down in the concourse area there, and he was smiling ear to ear, and he kind of chuckled. He said, hey, we're not done yet.
God.
I said, oh, please. All right, here's the kickoff by number 22.
Guthrie.
Hodge. Guthrie's got the ball. Going to cut up over his own 20 and be wrestled down by number 5, Ife.
Ife Onyenem, and again, a big tackle. He's had a tremendous game today. Number 5.
Yeah. I apologize. I'm doing the best with your last name. It is. And I'm not sure he can appreciate it.
His first name is pronounced Ife.
Ife,
so
yes.
We're going to
stick
call
with
Ife.
Onyenem. Onyenem. Yeah, that's it. Onyenem. Murray's having a ball just watching us here, trying to, you know, do our best. Yeah. Anyhow. All right. Abood hands the ball off right up the gut is Malloy, and he's got a gain of about 6. Boy, I like this kid too. Donovan Malloy, 23 points.
He came, I don't want to say from nowhere, Pete, but we expected this year Isaiah Smith carrying the load most of the time. With the injury, it's elevated Malloy to the number one spot.
Spencer Kennedy into the game, along with Jacob Thomas, the receivers end of things. Let's see, three receivers to the left, two to the right. There's a fake handoff, throw it out to Kane Stevenson. Stevenson's got the first down. Boy, he's a top runner. I like how they use him in the slot, you know.
For sure, Pete.
We saw him in the backfield a lot.
OJ Azor with the tackle.
Similar to that flat play that we saw the Laurier team use. Gryphon defense. All right, first down. Ball at the 37-yard line. Abood with three receivers to his right, two to his left. Lone setback is Malloy. Back to pass, throwing out into the slot. Again, another nice game. Get to the number
down.
In a moment there. That's number 7, Citizen Kane Stevenson. He's from Windsor, Ontario.
Fine gentleman. We
he's just super class.
A couple weeks ago when we were here, and he was a classic gentleman. One of the real senior leaders on this team.
Without question. First down now. Ball at the 48-yard line of the Gryphons. They continue to march down the field. There's the handoff to Malloy. He runs up the gut. He's going to gain about 4 before being hit there by
right
number
in the middle,
99.
We call Brandon Omanyua.
Yeah, Brandon.
Talk about plugging a hole.
Yeah, he's
sticking his nose in there. What a play.
All right. Here we go, second down and five. Three receivers to the left, two out here to the right. Boot. Takes the snap, back to pass, pressure up the middle, stepping in, he is brought down, and is that?
That's
number 98 this time. That's Luke Brubaker.
Brubaker wraps him up.
And that's gonna force a punt. Boy, he was just getting ready. You could see here to let her fly, and Brubaker just nailed
wraps him up. And that Laurier bench is on fire, Pete. And there's Brubaker.
Yeah. Good shot of the Golden Hawks. High end, a punt is blocked! And it's gonna be a smart play there. By, I think that was number 49.
Sebastian Parasaldias.
Yeah, Garrett Cardino fell on it. Punter himself, but getting through, and boy, big special play there by, what's this? Getting through, and what a block.
What a reach, eh, with the right hand.
T. Gardino doing the right thing, folks. Yep. Hustling after falling on it. Marks the ball at the 30-yard line. Bit of excitement as they're firing Harvey's. Harvey's, what a partnership they have out here with this.
Pete.
Their burgers and chicken.
Their burgers are incredible. They're awesome.
Well, and I watched last week. I think you had 7 pickles on your burger.
Well, it was all you could eat pickles.
Oh,
and in my household, that counts as a salad. So that loaded up, but. No, great environment here. It's orientation day. They've been back to school for a couple days, we were told.
Yeah.
And a festive environment, unfortunately not on the scoreboard, Pete. But
yeah, it's 46-13, and Laurier has the ball at the 30-yard line. But you know, next time we're in this booth, Sean, it's homecoming.
Oh,
and the York
Yeoman,
they're the York,
are they still the Yeoman?
York Lions are coming to town. They used to be the Yeoman folk back then.
Yeah.
All right.
Here we go, Pete.
4 receivers to the right, 1 setback, 1 receiver here to the left. Elgersma. He's back to pass. He's got all time to kind. Going to throw it long and deep to Jordan. Wide open. Touchdown! Taylor Elgersma.
Pete, just all types of room.
Yeah.
Ethan Jordan, I mean, leading the country last year with.
Well, he's from Chatham, Ontario, so I got to give a shout out to my hometown.
But Pete, here's the setup.
Look at this.
And this is
pitch and catch. Now, look, here is not a defender. Andy Malcolm James is the closest, and they're kind of looking around saying, I thought you had him, maybe, but anyhow, it's 52-13. And the ball is going to be snapped here. And Mr. Hodge makes it 53-14 for Laurier with 6:27 to go here in the third quarter, Sean. And
boy, Pete, just out of town, I got a couple quick scores here for you. McMaster leading York 45-0 at the end of the first half. Windsor 15, Waterloo 0. And that big bad Windsor team on the road. Beating up right now Waterloo. A little bit of buzz around the OUA about Windsor right now, Pete. They really
is.
They seem to really turn the corner in their program. And we've met J.P. Cicelli here, and he's got that squad looking well. McMaster, after that great effort last week at Western, pouring it on against York. Other games a little later today. Queens at Toronto, Western at Carleton up in Ottawa.
Be a bit of a road trip for the Mustangs, eh?
Sure.
Yeah, we got to give a shout out to the Buick family. We met them. They've
what
got a young
joy.
Recruit.
Outstanding.
From Kingston, Ontario. Very good. Son isn't dressing yet, but who knows? He loves this university, that's for sure, and a nice run back here.
We're trying to get a number here. Number 81. I believe that's Jacob Thomas. The receiver as well.
Get some time on special teams.
That Guelph defense needs a bit of Guelph has to put together a bit of a drive and some possession time here.
Yeah, 6:19 and counting, third quarter. All of a sudden the play clock down to 12 seconds. So Abood is going to have to make sure he's got everybody in line and in order. 4-3, is he going to get it off in time? And he does. Here's the fake handoff, and looking, throwing it long and deep to Genesis. And that ball, and we have a flag on the play. And there was interference prior to Genesis grabbing the ball.
Pete, the DB, just stuck an arm in there and interfered with them. But again, another great ball by Abood.
Perfect pass, perfect. See right there, he
grabbed
the shoulder.
Yeah,
that's right. That's the right call. Automatic first down. Now, it's not a spot foul. So they march off that penalty, and that allows the Gryphons to bring the ball out to their 44-yard line. The line of scrimmage. Good shot of Tristan Abood. Boy, we talked to him week one. What a nice kid he is, too, eh? All
for
smiles,
sure.
Excited to be playing this sport. Here's a fake handoff, throw across the middle. What a nice catch there by Thomas.
That's Thomas, Jacob Thomas, getting in the lineup.
Good pass. Another first down, ball at the 54-yard line into Laurier territory.
Boy, Pete, you like those plays. That real quick pass.
Yeah.
Just a couple step drop by Abood and a quick pass over the middle. You got to like that play from Guelph.
Genesis out here to the right. He's got single coverage. Abood again, back to pass. Quick hitter out in the slot. Is that Arsenal? What a game he's had. Make that first man miss. Got another 2 yards.
Number
Willem
five,
Arsenal.
Pete.
Boy, nice pass right on the flat. Catch. Make one miss. And number 20, who is Duncan Naughty. We called his name a couple of times.
Naughty's a big hitter there for Laurier.
First
wrapped
down.
Him up.
Ball at the 43-yard line of the Golden Hawks. Abood. Looks like it's just pretty much pass mode right now. Why not? You're down a pant load. Stepping up in the pocket. He's going to take off and run. He's down and makes one man miss. He's continuing to run, and look at him go! He's all the way to the 22-yard line. Tristan Abood.
Pete looked like he was going down, made a quick move to his right, and another big play. There's been nothing wrong with Tristan Abood's play today. Pete, watch his quick move here. All of a sudden, a sidestep.
It's
like a basketball move.
Yep.
You know,
got it.
That sidestep in the lane, as you used to do.
I remember the days. That was the early 70s.
Yeah.
All right. Here's the handoff. Malloy tries to get to the outside, and boy, you know, that's one thing I like about Malloy. He took on that linebacker.
For sure.
No, I'm not going to go around you, number five. Ivy, I'm going to try to go through you. Kudos to Ivy. He held him up. Watch this, folks. Drop the shoulder. Bingo. Try to get that extra yard. No fear in number 23. Second down and nine.
Very good group tackling by Laurier. They hound that ball, Pete.
Four receivers to the left. Now coming in motion is Citizen Kane Stevenson. Abood back to pass. He's looking. Throws it over to the side. And that one hit. Was that Arsenal out there? No, I don't think so.
It's a double digit number, Pete. Is that
number 14? Ryan Ogilvy. All right.
This
looks
was
like, let me see.
Pete, that's another good ball.
Yeah, it is.
20
like
made a nice
arm
play
in there.
Naughty again.
Well, this is where it's third down and you go for it, because I don't want 3 points. It's not going to help me when I'm down 53-13. 2:50 to go here in the third quarter. Abood, in search of that first down or touchdown. He's back to pass. Whistle blows right away, and let's see what the call is.
It appears to be a time count again, Pete.
Yeah, it is. Time count. They'll move it back. Five. That hurts.
Yeah, that's tough on Coach Sheehan.
Yeah. But again, these are growing pains of a young quarterback. These are, you know, we saw him run the ball magically, and then Again, sometimes you get excited and you lose track of time. It's going to be third down and about 14, Sean, to get the first down. They can get a first down down around the 15-yard line, it looks like. Let's see what happens. Fakes the handoff. Back to pass. Throws a little screen pass, trying to get up the middle, and going to be well short is Malloy. And we will
Ivy, number five, with another big tackle. He's been a beast today.
Yeah.
The word for it. He's been outstanding. Number five.
Yeah.
He's
their
Oyemenem.
Oyemenem.
Number five. Check where he's from. We've called his name so much today.
Down there, he's from Toronto. All right, back to handoff there, and oh, fine defense by the Gryphons there. They needed that. Number 44 assisting on that tackle. Yusuf
Al-Khadi had a great first game here.
Watch that, good play, and he had some assistance there. Miles Lafoucade had a nice chat with him before the game. All right, here we go, Sean. No gain on the play. It's second and long. Here we go.
Look out on the outside here, Pete.
Back to pass, looking. There's the old stop and go, looking deep and out of bounds. That ball was not catchable. And here is something we have not seen a lot of, Sean.
Second punt of the day.
Of the day. We're introducing the punt team again.
They had to wake the punter.
He was watching reruns of Hee-Haw like I was.
There's that big pass down the sideline. A little bit of hands, but nothing going on.
Oh, goodness. All right. Punt off the side of his foot. But a good Laurier bounce. Trying to get to the outside, and can he make it? No, he can't. Good defensive play there. The special teams, boy, they've had good special teams.
You know,
number 16
they
there.
Really have Pete.
Joel Gilmore. I wonder if he's any relation to the great Doug Gilmore from Kingston, Ontario, Sean.
I knew we'd get a Maple Leaf reference in there somehow. Boy, Anakin has just had a tough time on punt returns today, Pete. Hard time getting around the corner. They've tracked him pretty good all day.
All right, Tristan Abood. Here he comes out here again. He's going to get his offense started from their own 39-yard line. 1:06 to go in the third quarter. 53-13 is the score for the Golden Hawks. If you're just joining us, there's that nice pass and catch and first down, and rumbling for even more is number 19, Craig Sherrington.
His second catch of the day.
Boy, you talk about
He put
watch this,
down.
Folks. He gets contact right here. Now watch how far he continues to go. Five more yards. Good for you, Mr. Sherrington. First down. Ball at the 53-yard line. All right, back to pass. Looking at Boots. Going to take off and run. And he's got some room. And look at him go. 40. 35, and all the way to the 32-yard line. Tristan Abood. This kid, if he stays healthy, Sean, is going to have a whale of a football career at this university.
You betcha, Pete. Tracked by number 25, Yohari Hastings. Hastings came all the way across the field to make that tackle.
Well, they're going to give Abood a rest because here comes the new marshal in town, Marshall McCray. Two exciting young quarterback, athletic quarterbacks, guys that hadn't taken a snap in the OUA their whole lives until this year. All right, McCray fakes the handoff, makes the player, and look at him go. And boy, you talk about a triple threat.
He turns nothing into something, Pete, every time.
Made that defensive end miss.
He was stopped.
It's the end of the third quarter.
Get that tackle there, Pete. Number five again. Ife, what an effort. Ife.
Yeah, he's had a big game, has he not?
Yes.
My goodness.
I think he was second team all OUA last year.
There's the score, 53-13. We're going to go down to the field here, and you can see the... I know you've always wanted to get into one of those rolling things. I'd like to see you take on Murray Drinkwater for the whole ball of wax in those things.
Well,
I'd pay money to see that.
I can't speak for Murray, but there's no chance either one of us would find ourselves in that. I'm going to go out on a limb there. And
Well, Murray just gave the thumbs up.
Hey, listen, Pete, while I get a chance, I know we have lots of people who listen around the country, parents and families of different players. I have family over in Korea, and I know...
Oh, he's tuning us in.
I know the Big E, Tiffany, the Marvelous Maeve, the Big Little E. They're at tonight, I would assume, a new place called Near Mint, a fantastic restaurant and bar in beautiful Seoul, South Korea, tuning us in. Actually, they're not tuning us in. It's 4 in the morning there, so... They'll watch this on demand.
I think the Big E will get up. You know,
just big kudos to them. My chance here to say hello to the crew.
Beautiful.
Over on Jeju Island in Seoul, South Korea.
Marshall McCray, number one. First down, Gryphons.
I'm trying to see who made this tackle, Pete, as you see on the replay.
What's the move here, Sean? Right here. Boom to the left. Boom. Make that guy miss.
Just great vision.
He looked like Barry Sanders, I'm telling you.
95. Jahari Hastings finally got his hands on him.
Matt Caruso had him dead to rights, but he made Caruso miss. And Abood back in. So there's a 1-2 punch these Gryphons have at quarterback on offense. Abood back to pass, throwing it in the end zone to Genesis. Touchdown, Gryphons!
And boy,
number 11!
Pete, do I love that play. He zeroed in on him. He is the go-to man here in Guelph. A real leader on this team. And Abood zeroed in on him right from the get-go. Threw a ball. We'll take a look on the replay in a minute. It looked
oh,
like
yeah.
he sorted to the back shoulder.
Number 11, Mr. Excitement. Watch it. Oh, great field shot. Watch him. He's going to come right into your living room. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful play. And very unfortunate for number 28, Cote Azor, who's had a very good game for these Golden Hawks. But that time, Genesis got the best of him. 53-19, the possibility of it being 20.
Two-point conversion.
Oh, I like this. Lots of motion. Genesis hustling out to the right.
Don't sleep on Kane Stevenson, number 7.
Back to pass, looking, throwing, and back to, and is it caught? It is! What a play!
Vishon.
Genesis, oh my goodness, Sean. He went inside and then cut back out. Watch this, folks. He's looking there all the way. Stop. Oh, man.
Slip.
Stop on a dime. And
a rocket.
Io didn't have a chance. Great pigeon catch there for the Deuce. That makes it 53-21. Even Murray Drinkwater here nodding his head saying, hey, that's an impressive play. There's a great shot of, as I like to call him, Sega Genesis.
Well, we talked to him just about before every game, Pete, and he is one focused young man. This is a big year for him. I know last year how frustrated he was at times, and we have got a fine-looking young quarterback here in Guelph.
Oh, yeah.
He throws a rocket, Pete. He's a rocket man. He really is.
He did say he liked Elton John, too, in some of his music. Well, there you go.
Maybe there's a connection there.
You never know. All right, here's the kickoff, folks. From their own 45-yard line, it's blasted down into the end zone. And bringing it out, trying to cut up the middle, and boom, hit hard around the 21-yard line. We'll get you a number
That's
in a moment.
56 right in the middle.
Mr. Holmes.
Maxwell Holmes. We've called his name a couple times tonight, Max. He's just a second-year kid. He's a defensive lineman, too, Pete. It was interesting when we were talking to the Toronto coach a couple weeks ago. He was telling us how, you know, the CFL draft, they look for kids that can also play special teams.
You know, Nicholas Gardero was in on that tackle, too.
He's been in there a couple times
There's
today.
A draw play, and it's a good one, but good Guelph defense. 1, 2, 3, finally brought down by Lafourcade. Jack Cobb.
I'll tell you,
hit him
Pete,
once.
Miles Lafourcade, he has had a great game today. He has been all over this field. He's going to be one tired kid after all this. He's gone sideline to sideline.
Yeah, Lafourcade, a good tackle. I'm going to tell you, that running back, Quint Scott, is tough to bring down. It's second down and six, and another big second and long play. Can the Gryphon defense get this team off the field? There's the throw well out into the flat, wide open out there, and caught, and that's going to be a first down all the way out to the 46-yard line.
And he can.
That's Braden 31. Thorne.
Zach Valentine, I believe, 31.
On the tackle.
On the tackle. That's the first time we called Zach's name. First-year kid. Zach Thorne.
Thorne's had a big day. They've got a 1-2 punch, Thorne and Jordan.
Really a 1-1 punch, really.
Yeah.
It's a left and a right hook.
Coming from the outside and trying to get it, throwing it over to the men, just overthrown. And Taylor knows that one was just a little too far.
Well, he's had the touch all day, Pete, so that's, we're going to.
He was looking for number 83, Jace Atkinson. You can see here, he rolls to the right. And rolling, and throws it just a little too far.
And you wonder, Pete, how long Michael Folds would keep Taylor in the game.
Yeah, 12:40 to go here in the fourth quarter.
Excuse me.
53-21. Back to pass again, looking. He's going to step up and try to run, throws it out into the flat. And breaking that tackle, and that was a key, because that allowed that first down to take place.
Pete, the move he puts on the man outside. I'm not sure who that was.
That's Quint Scott. Made the catch. Watch this. Scott stays and then
stays
all of a sudden hides out. Almost a backwards pass there.
And that was Braden McDougal that he beat on that play, Pete. For a big man, he has really got some moves.
First down ball at the 54-yard line of the Gryphons as they are now in to Gryphon territory, 12-19 and counting to go here in the fourth quarter. Elgersma takes the handoff, throws, takes a shot, and it's hit hard, but
bounces
right back
up.
And that
Lafourcade on the tackle again. We'll get the number on who made that catch.
I think that's Jordan. He's getting up just a little gingerly there. You can see him coming off the field.
Looks like an ankle. Oh, no way.
Oh, he said, hey, I'm from Chatham, Ontario. You don't get me off the field. Good for you, kid. There's the fake handoff. Back to pass. They throw it out on the flat. Another nice play. We saw a ton of this play in the first half. And that's going to get another first down all the way to the 41-yard line.
Jackson Stebbings with that catch, Pete, from Elgersma.
Yeah, look at that touch on the ball. Yeah. Pitch and catch. Lafourcade knocked him out of bounds. Now, he's calm and cool. Elgersma is in that quarterback position. Delight to watch. The handoff up the middle. And good tackle there. Boy, that's how you go. 91, Robert Keyes Wilson in there. Grabbed him by the shoestrings, and Jack Cobb finished him off. Watch
second
this.
Second-year kid, Pete.
Watch this, Sean, right here. Right down 91, got him right there. And then Jack Cobb, my namesake, getting it done. Good for you, 55. Second and long. Three receivers to the right. Make it four. One setback. Back to pass, again, all kinds of time, and in across the middle, what a pitch and catch, and a great catch it was by number 83,
Jace
Atkinson.
What a catch,
it
Pete.
Was.
This was an absolute bullet.
A little bit behind him, watch this, folks, and he reached back to make this catch. It shows in the arm of Elgersman, look at that. That is a beauty, wow. First down now, all the way to the 13-yard line, and the Laurier Golden Hawks are knocking on the door.
Nicholas Parchenko down here getting some medical attention, hopefully just a cramp.
Yeah, it's
see. He's a second year kid too.
You know, as we have a moment, Sean, I want to extend across to all those people. We lost a member, Jay Brody, passed away. Just a fantastic gentleman, and we send out his wife, Lynn, and Laura, and the family, and of course, TJ, son TJ, and I'm talking about TJ Brody, who plays for the Toronto Maple Leafs. The Brody family, just wonderful, 62 years old, and our deepest sympathies are sent out to the Brody family. All right, the ball is at the 13-yard line.
After that incredible catch by Jace Atkinson, number 83.
Well, their receiving core, there's nothing wrong with them in Laurier. That's for darn sure. The fake run up, let's see what happens at the second attempt. Here's the handoff. And breaking one tackle and busting his way all the way down to the 1 yard line. Quinton Scott, and I'm telling you, number 14, he is impressive. He's a runaway train when he gets loose. Watch this, folks.
So much room here on the line. Just
Jack Cobb almost had him. Look at the guys diving, trying to get him.
There's so much room there breaking that. First line of defense.
This Gryphon defense is just worn out.
Who do you like here, Quinton Scott?
I would be. Look at that massive offensive line.
Maybe not.
Keeper and just skating in is the Taylor Algersma. Touchdown. Laurier, that makes it 59-21 with the extra point. Watch this, folks.
This is too easy, Pete. Yeah. 41 closing the outside corner here. That was Sebastian Parsalidis. In the film next week, we'll talk about that corner, number 41, closing it off. So.
Algersma
can just walk in.
The extra point is good, folks. And with 9:19 to go, it's the Laurier Golden Hawks 60 and the Guelph Gryphons 21. And, you know, I guess we talked about it last week. There were a bunch of points, I think 41, that Windsor put up on this Guelph defense. And I think offensively, if I'm Coach Shane, I'm feeling pretty good about my offense. I really am. They're young. But we got to get things fixed on the other side of the ball. And,
for sure, Pete. And
there's some good quarterbacks around this OUA.
Oh, for sure.
They can expose you.
Well, the secondary has really been victimized today. I mean, that's easy to say because there's no real pressure up front.
Right.
But it's certainly an area that we got concerned about it last year
when we
saw the how they ran against them, Guelph. But a lot of youngsters on this team. Hopefully in the future we get Murray back and, of course, the Torpedo.
Yeah.
Wishing the Torpedo all the best.
Oh, boy.
Anthony
had
Soprano
nice chat
Mortis.
With his dad today.
Had a
he
great
talked
chat
about
with
community and
yep.
how important life is outside of football and how these coaches help out.
For sure.
Here's a nice little run back right up the gut and all the way to the 31-yard line.
And that's number 13. That's Kyle Simon Guerin.
Oh, yeah.
He's a great special teams player. I've noticed
first
a couple
year
of
kid, eh?
Big tackles last time by him.
Watch him cut up the middle here, folks. Gets ahead of steam going.
Oh, boy, going through that line nice and high. Be careful. You'll
great receiver throwing a block for him. Christian Abood now with the ball at his own 31-yard line.
We saw Vishon with a couple of tremendous catches on that last drive, Pete. Let's see if they can find them
again.
Take
the handoff. They get it out to Citizen Kane Stevenson in the flat. He makes 1-2. Boy, it takes 3-4-5. Look at 6. There's a flag. And I think there might have been some, like a punch.
Yeah, it looks like.
Not a punch to hurt him, but to try to move the ball.
Yeah.
free the ball because there were five guys trying to take down Kane Stevenson.
I think maybe Nico McCarthy came in, number three.
Yeah. Face mask. Wow, there you go.
He came in a little aggressive there.
No quitting, citizen Kane Stevenson, Mr. Moynihan.
What a message he's sending the rest of these youngsters on the Guelph team.
Count the white shirts that it takes to bring him down. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. He still finally goes down when the 10th guy comes in. Incredible. And we are getting number 12 warming up on the sidelines, Isaac Willis. So we might see him next offensive series. As number 20 is coming off, Duncan Noddy, a little shaken up.
He's had a great game
today. Well, he's running off, so he looks to be in good shape. Ball at the 50-yard line of the Gryphons after the penalty gives them a first down. And a boot. Genesis way out there to the right. Coming over here to the near side, Jared Tessier, number 88. Stevenson in motion. Abood back to pass. Look, fakes, throws, and he was hit as he was thrown. And boy, he had Thomas open across the middle. Murray Drinkwalder, always a pleasure. Good to see you, sir, and we'll see you at homecoming, hopefully.
Murray was his greeting, sights up here. And
oh, he laughs at our jokes, too. I mean, you know, when you got an audience that'll do that. Because Ginny and Patty really don't do that a lot.
Sure.
Not enough.
Well, we got a 2-hour drive with them, too. And
goodness gracious.
I hope our viewing audience has some pity for us here, you know. I'm sure they do.
All right. Abu turns, reverses the other way. The ball is caught by Genesis. He makes one player miss. He's going to gain about 2 yards. It's going to be third down. And let's see what Coach Shane says. We're going for it.
I think that was Ivan Zhu. We haven't called his name today. Number 92 in for a tackle.
All right. Here we
third
go.
Third and seven.
Third and seven. Ball at their own 53-yard line. Back to pass. Looking. Throwing across the middle. Ball's caught. First down. What a pitch and catch. Jacob Thomas with the reception.
I love the play, Pete.
Third year kid.
It's a bullet to Thomas, as you can see here.
Look at the boot. Stand tall, step and throw. Bingo. Hands reach up. Caught, brought down by number 25, Jahari Hastings. Ball now into Laurier Golden Hawk territory. 7:08 counting. Commanding lead by the Golden Hawks, but the Gryphons are on the move.
See, number 88, Jared Tessier's in the game.
All right, here's the pass into the flat. It's caught. And that is Citizen Kane Stevenson. And one man is not bringing him down. It takes two. Good sportsmanship there by number 33, Jaden Griffiths, helping him up. Watch this. One guy says, hey, I know I got to go low on him. And a third guy comes in to help bring him down.
Ethan Gregoric.
Second down and four, Sean. Three receivers to the left, one of them being number seven. Two to the right. Genesis is out wide right. Blitz coming. Throw, and the ball's batted down into the middle. They were looking for Stevenson.
They had him, Pete.
And he would have been gone, too.
We'll take a look at the replay and see who got a hand on it. Might have been 99 again.
Laurier defense dial up a blitz there.
No. No, it was 50. Again, we're having a hard time getting the number.
Good defensive play regardless.
Gorsuch again.
All right, second down, third down.
And five,
and,
Pete.
Five. Another big third down play. Can the Gryphons convert? Another blitz coming. And sacked. Big play there by number 25, Jahari Hastings.
And number 5-2, Ife in there again today. Ife, look out.
Watch this.
Pete,
no time.
No chance.
Good block there by Malloy.
25 made the initial, Jahari Hastings.
Have a moment, we'll enjoy the sack race over there. Today we have 2, 4, 6, 8 participants on. Last game when there were no students there. There were only two. They asked you and I to go in it.
You know our answer to that. Hey, Pete, looking ahead to next week in the OUA, Waterloo will travel to Laurier. Not much of a travel there. That'll be a Kitchener-Waterloo area. That'll be a buzz, won't it? Windsor travels up to Ottawa. Carleton takes on York. Western travels to Queens. You might want to keep your eye on that game. And Guelph here will just travel, an hour away, and take on McMaster.
All right, well, Sean, here comes number 12, Isaac Willis. Now, try to find his name here, Isaac Willis, first-year kid from Milton, Ontario, communication study, 6'3", 175. And we got a late whistle here.
Half the offensive line moved. Running back, quarterback did not. Like, so it's going to be a procedure.
There was a dead play. No penalty assessed.
Okay.
They're going to do it all over again with 8 seconds left on the play clock. And now they're going to run out of time. Yeah. Oh, timeout. It's called the timeout. Willis calling him over. Say, okay, you got it. Look at this. Here comes Taylor Algersma, too. Give his support. Saying, hey, kid, don't worry about it. Make sure you look at those end zone clocks. What a day for Taylor Algersma.
Oh, boy.
He stepped up as a prime time player.
I'm afraid to look at the numbers. I mean, I can only think of four or five passes that maybe that weren't complete. He has been on the money, and he has really been magical all day long.
All right, here we go. Hand off, and making his way up the middle, and let's see what number, get a number.
Pete, I'm
like number two, I think, Sean.
And now we'll get a... It is
Tanner
number
Nelms.
Two. Tanner Nelms in the game.
Kind of hoping to see number 34 in there, Darian Bassett-Hadden.
You know, Pete, on the score sheet, they had him returning a kickoff. And I just don't remember that.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's an error.
Well, anyhow, his dad, Mike, is in the crowd. Another Chatham kid.
From our hometown.
Outstanding athlete. Mike Hadden, his dad was an exceptional volleyball basketball player. Played for Victor Morrison, your good and our good friend, the great Bob Chinnick, known as the fastest man in Wallaceburg. All right, here we go. Isaac Willis.
Will he continue to hand off the ball here, Pete, and chew up the clock? And yes, he will.
I think so. Here's a little pitch to the outside, getting some blocks. And nice defensive play, fighting off the block at 39, I believe. Gianni Green, Sean, came across and made the tackle. It's going to be third down, and here comes the punt team.
Gianni Green and Kyle Simon are doing really nice tag team there on this, Pete, reading each other's move.
Simon Gehring
forced him back inside.
What a beautiful kick. Looking for that Coffin corner. It does go out of bounds.
Beautiful kick.
Yeah, it was out of bounds around the 6-yard line, Sean. Back judge Darren Cochran has marked it.
Not a real long ride home for Laurier tonight, Pete, but that bus will be rocking.
Oh, it'll be 3:47 to go. 60-21 is the score for the Golden Hawks. If you're just joining us. And the Gryphons will start from their own 6-yard line. And there's another weapon, a special team punter. And it looks like Marshall McCray is in at quarterback. He's got lots of motion, lots of movement. And he fakes the handoff, and he rolls to the right. He's going to throw a bullet out there, and it is dropped. and brought down out of bounds. I didn't see who that was intended.
I think it's number five.
Five, Pete. Yes.
And that's Willem Arsenal.
And he's had a good game, but that ball was quite catchable. I remember. Look at how he throws
this
ball.
This is a rocket
on
the run. This is a Patrick Mahomes ball.
Yeah, watch this, folks. Step and zip.
A little high, but
catchable.
Yeah.
Get both hands on it. And I think running. Well, it's second down and 10. A new marshal in town, Mr. McCray, takes a snap, and we got a offside, it looks like, or maybe a time violation.
I think it could be time again. P, I see a zero up there.
Kevin Baird. Time is 12. He's got a Kevin Baird, your referee.
We don't talk enough about the guys who play on those lines. Piles at the center. Ethan Pyle. Brother plays in Toronto.
Yeah.
We don't talk about those guys enough in the trenches.
58 to go. Just joining us again at 60 for Laurier and 21 for Guelph. However, let's see what Mark's doing. Second string guys.
Yeah, other guys getting an opportunity
to play on the defense. There's a helmet that keeps flying up. Number 90. Ivan E. All right, second down and 3. Ball at the 43-yard line of the Gryphons. Marshall McCray, back to pass. He's looking, throws, got a man open. First down. Oh, a punishing hit. Oh, my goodness. Number 89, Laurent Paquin. Sean, watch this replay.
And by Pete, number 30, Brady Lyons. Lionheart, but watch Lionheart get up and go back to the ball after this hit.
Bang! Right, knocked
now
right
watch
up.
This.
He does
goes
it quick.
Back.
You gotta love that. I agree with you.
You gotta love that fight in. But wow, that's the biggest hit of the game so far.
Back to pass. McCray throws it across the middle and a sliding grab there by number 11. Is that our man? Nope, not Jacob Thomas, number 81. Another first down. Nice little.
I like that pass, Pete. Very safe over the middle.
137 and counting. Let's see if Marshall can lead him to the pay dirt.
We saw this last week in Windsor when Marshall came in, really moving the team.
Big blitz. Here's the draw play. Breaking a tackle and hustling up. That's number 32, Sean, and that is Mason Duvall. 5'11". Second year kid, got a player down. It looks like it might be
Jared Tessier. We have not met Jared Tessier yet. First year kid, number 88.
Check
him down. He's a receiver they have him listed as. But good news is he's up on his feet, walking off on his own.
Welland, Ontario. All right, here we go. Second down. Second down and 4 or 5. Another blitz coming. And look out, McCray gets to the outside. He's gonna have a first down and more, Sean. He tries to cut into the middle. And look at him make people miss. Oh, is this kid exciting? All the way to the 20-yard line.
But, Pete, I think once in a while you got to step out of bounds. He is on the sideline, and we just could not afford another injury here. But what moves, and he is something else.
Oh, man, you talk about stomping a dime, folks. Barry Sanders reincarnated as a quarterback.
He is Barry-esque, isn't he?
He really is. go back and YouTube Sanders. I think it's a young Marshall McCray.
Back on track. Again, a lot of new young bodies in. Here we go.
Right, McCray back looking. He slips a bit and is going to be brought down. He just slipped that inch. He was stepping up in the pocket. And they'll lose probably, let's see, 4 yards. It's going to be down.
Second and 14.
Ball at the 25-yard line.
Block running.
37 and counting.
Vishon is back in the game. Pete over here, number 11.
He's on our side of the field. The blitz.
He's coming across the middle.
Oh, and just a little low. Boy, he was open. That would have been enough for a first down with Kane Stevenson. And now it's third down. And you just say, hey, I'm going to kick a field goal.
You take a look through the feet. He had him. Just didn't really step into that ball, did he?
A little low.
He'd like
yep.
to have that back.
All right, Mr. McCray. Lead us to a 15-yard gain and another first down, or lead us to Pater. Here we go.
Single coverage on Vishon out here.
Back to pass. Got time. They're looking for Genesis, and it's well overthrown. And that will do it for the offensive thrust there. And here comes Mr. Willis. Back in, number 12.
And he's going to eat up Willis. 20 seconds if he can.
I think you'll probably see him take a knee, I would imagine. A couple of times, and that probably should do it. And they are in victory formation. And I must say, did I enjoy when Jared Goff took victory formation on Thursday night. Thank you very much. Go Lions.
Well, Peter, this has been the Tyler Eldridge must show today.
Just remarkable.
What a display. And, as I said earlier, I'm trying to think how many passes have been incomplete. I mean, only two incompletions in the first half.
There you have it, folks. That's the ball game. And again, the final score, the Laurier Golden Hawks 60, the Guelph Gryphons 21. And Mr. Moynihan, I guess, you know, if we reflect on this game, I don't, you know, our offensive woes seem to kind of correct themselves. I feel really good about Tristan Abood and Marshall McCray.
For sure, Pete. And, you know, right from the get-go, though, Eldersma, Jordan, Scott, they were just basically unstoppable on defense, you know. So that's Guelph's focus. It's going to be maybe more pressure on that quarterback. Again, easy for us to stay up top here. But, boy, what an effort by this team.
Well, they're 3-0. The Golden Hawks are a team to be reckoned with, as you mentioned. And here's one of the great traditions in U-Sport, folks. You respect your opponent. You shake hands. The coaching staff all shakes hands. And says good luck in your venture wherever you're heading. And same to the opposing team. And now the team meeting. And, boy, you can just tell by the walk of the coaching staff of the Gryphons there. It's been a long day for them.
It has
been a long day,
Pete,
for the defense.
And, Pete, it's pretty much started on the first possession by Laurier today when they drove the field and had a touchdown. And Ethan Jordan, unstoppable almost today. And just what an effort. And we're going to hope we're going to get to go down on the field. I don't know if anybody would really want to interview the coach at this time, but one of the things, yeah, Pete, about Coach Sheehan, he's great with us.
Oh,
he's great
he
with
really
the media.
Is.
You know.
Oh, he doesn't run and hide. No way.
He's going to find a way to build this team,
yep,
and build them up and get them ready for the next game. That's on to Mac. That will not be easy.
Oh, my.
Mac just seems to be coming into their own.
Even though they're 0-2, they're...
Yeah, they're going to win today, so
yeah,
they're going to be 1-2, just like Guelph. And, you know, next week gets us to the halfway point of the season. And all of a sudden, you know, at that halfway point, you start thinking and playoff position. And we know seven teams make the playoffs. Okay.
All right, let's send it down to Madupe and Mr. Slam Dunk for their postgame thoughts.
Hello, Griffin fans, and the final score of today's game is going to be the Golden Hawks 60 to Guelph Gryphons 21. Unfortunately, the Guelph Gryphons did fall short today, but it's definitely not for a lack of effort. Good job today, boys. What were the positive outtakes on Guelph's game today?
First of all, you have to realize their entire starting linebacking core was out, right?
Yeah.
Anthony Mortuzzo was a player of the game in week one, was not on the field. I thought Jack Cobb did a valuable job stepping up, led the team with eight tackles today. And overall on offense, I thought they looked pretty good. Did they put up 60 points? No. 21, but Tristan Abood, the rookie quarterback, goes 22 of 31, 277 yards, touchdown, no picks. So I really liked his confidence. Marshall McCray did his thing in a package role there, came in and boosted the offense. And Willem Arsenault led the team in receiving today. 17 years old, this guy is. So I really like the potential here on offense, but they got to start putting things together. Most importantly, got to get after the opposing passer. They're going to have to do that to have success the rest of the year.
Absolutely. Boys, definitely keep your head held high. That's going to do it for us here today. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We will see you next time here at Alumni Stadium, September 23rd for homecoming. So definitely be sure to tune in then and bring the energy, bring the spirit, and hopefully we'll get a win then. Thank you guys so much. We'll be right back.